Welcome to the Deminski and Doyle Show on demand. Thanks to our sponsor, New Look Home Design, home improvement made easy. Don't forget to follow this show so you'll never miss a minute. Thanks to our sponsor, The Men with Tools, worry-proof window and door replacement, real lifetime warranties. Visit themenwithtools.com. New Jersey
101.5. Easy sport. Got myself out of Beirut once. I think I can get out of New Jersey.
Yeah? Well, don't be so sure. Others have tried and failed. The entire population, in fact.
His arm was facing towards New Jersey, you see? And that's south. So then naturally they call him Southpaw.
As you know, I was from Jersey. I'm going back to Jersey and starting up a business again.
Don't even tell me you met her down the shore.
And was planning a class field trip to a French bread factory in Trenton.
All I said was the Easter Bunny at the Menlo Park Mall was more convincing.
Now do you blow it out?
Hello, I'd like two tickets to New Jersey, please.
Jersey's sold out, sir.
What?
That's a lovely accent you have. New Jersey?
Live from New Jersey, it's Deminski and Doyle.
Hi, good afternoon. It's the D&D Show. We are Deminski and Doyle. I'm Jeff Deminski.
Hey, Doyle, get on that radio.
And I'm Bill Doyle. So, man, Christmas is getting close.
Yes, it is.
And you and I have today and tomorrow. And then it's going to be like it was the last 6 weeks. We're not going to see each other a lot. No, I mean, people are taking vacations. And at some point along the line here in the station's history, they wanted us to start splitting up the vacations.
Because too many people were on vacation.
Yeah, yeah. So I'm going to be on next week, and you're taking off, and I'm going to be then you're going to be here, and I'll be off that following week.
It's true.
Yeah. I could tell you about some really, really cool plans that I've got.
Sure.
If I had any, but I don't.
Oh.
So do you have anything?
I was thinking, if I'm up to it, I might give getting a haircut a try.
See, I didn't know that was a plan, but then I do have plans. Yes, I may do that as well.
Yeah, if I'm up to it.
Yeah. And it's real exciting, too, because Brenda, who cuts my hair, she's moving into a new place.
You have the same person?
Yeah.
Lucky.
I've been all over the map. I used to do like the, you know, Fantastic Sam's or Great Clips,
yes.
Or I Had a Guy, or, oh, do you remember the gay dude that was hysterical?
Yes.
That we used to have on the show? He cut my hair back in Michigan for...
he was hilarious.
Yeah, yeah. I'm kind of a hair whore. I'll have anybody cut my hair, you know? I'm all over the place. But anyway, yeah, it'll be restful, hopefully. So, tomorrow is Friday. We're going to be doing our end of the week game, of course. We'll have some prizes to give away tomorrow. And there's a lot to get to today. There's a couple of things going on one in the legislature, but one that is just being talked about by Governor Murphy. They are still kicking around that idea in the legislature about later start times for high schools.
Yeah.
And Homedel is now going to be giving it a shot. We'll talk about that later on. But also, the minimum wage is going up, and it's finally cresting that $15 mark.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be on January 1st, the minimum wage in New Jersey for almost every job. There are a couple of, you know, carve-outs, like servers and things like that. But for the most part, minimum wage is going to be $15.13 an hour. But now Murphy, your governor, is saying, I don't know if that's enough.
Yeah.
He wants to maybe make it even higher.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, we'll talk about that later on. Right now, though, does anybody have a story? I hope you have a story that you would share. Because something happened last night that makes me want to talk about this. Were you ever involved with a vehicle that wasn't properly in park, or it popped out of park, however it happened, but it was a rollaway vehicle? Did you ever have it happen? 1-800-283-101.5. And when I'm saying rollaway vehicle, I mean, it doesn't even have to be your passenger car. You know, you could be operating a dump truck. I mean, that would be really scary.
Yeah, that'd be a little more serious.
Right? Much more weight. But right, any kind of vehicle, but it didn't stay where it was supposed to stay. That's the only criterion we have for this. And it could have happened when you were away from it. It could have happened right before your eyes. It could have happened when you were a half in and half out of it. None of those things matter. But were you ever involved with some sort of rollaway vehicle? 1-800-283-101.5. All right, because I have limited options because of having the little boys that I, you know, that I raise and have to deal with. And most of the time I have them. So I have limited opportunity to sit with my daughter and be the licensed driver for her practice driving. So last night, again, was one of those times. So we're getting a lot of night driving in.
Well, that's good.
You know, because that's harder.
It is.
Right. It is harder. We're getting a lot of night driving in because that's a lot of times when it falls. And so I had her, you know, after work, I had her drive me to the store and then a second place and then back home. And we'd practice some K-turns and things like that along the way.
How'd she do?
No, she's well, until the end. You can see where this is going.
Yes.
Until the end, she's doing great, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And I'll throw things at her, too, just to test her. Like, I won't tell her ahead of time. I'll be like, all right, right now, pull over, park at the curb. She's like, okay. All right, now do a K-turn. Well, yeah, but the store's up. Do a K-turn. I just bark the orders at her because this might be what they do. This might be exactly what they do in a test,
mm-hmm.
you know? So anyway, she was doing great. And we're all done. And so my guard is down. We're parked, I thought. We're at the curb, put it that way. And my street, it's street parking for her car.
Mm-hmm.
And it's fairly dark, okay? So you can't really see all that well. So this never happened before. I had no reason to think that this was going to happen. She stops the car. She's already out. I've got the door half open. I've got my body swung, and I'm putting my feet, because it's like a low car, you know, compared mm-hmm. to my SUV. So I'm putting my feet on the curbstone to get out of, because it's a Mazda 3, to get out of the Mazda. And the weirdest thing happens. I'm totally disoriented because my feet are immediately slipping, like sliding off the curb. But what it felt like in my mind, it didn't feel like the car was moving. It felt as if there was ice all over the curb
mm-hmm.
because I couldn't like get my feet to like grasp the curbstone, if you know what I mean.
I do.
Right? And I'm like, what is it? And I do it like two or three times in like 1 or 2 seconds. And I'm like, what the hell? It couldn't be icy. And all of a sudden, as I'm having that thought, I hear the driver's side door rip open. I hear my daughter going, oh my God. And then I turn, and then I got the visual through the windshield. And now I realize why she's yelling. There's no ice on the curb. It was that my feet were slipping off it because the car was rolling.
Ruh-roh.
I had no concept of it because it was dark. I wasn't expecting it, and I was disoriented. But she did exactly what she needed to do. She jumped back in. She didn't freeze because that's the number one thing people might do. And she got to the brake, and she stopped the car, and then she restarted the engine. But she never put it in park. And after like a perfect 45 minutes of driving, just
all undone by one mistake.
All undone by that one mistake. And of course, she was like nervously laughing about it. And because nothing bad happened, it was almost like a bonding moment because nothing bad happened.
Mm-hmm.
But it was rolling towards a big old pickup truck. And when she got it stopped, like, thank God she gave a big gap where she did leave it.
Mm-hmm.
But when she got it stopped, it was maybe about like 8 feet away where it started, probably about like 45 feet away.
Wow.
Yeah. So, I mean, this thing rolled. I mean, there is like a slant to that road that I wasn't aware of. And, it was just like one of the most disorienting things. But real quick, what I did do, though, as her coach driver, you know, I was like, okay, get back in. You're not going to leave it at this. I want you to drive down the road, go around the block, come back and repark. And she's like, why? I was like, because I don't want you to have this the last thing in your head. This was just a mistake. I don't want you to have this in your head and make it rattle you.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of like the whole get right back on the horse thing.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't want that in your head as the last thing that you did. I just want you to drive around just two more minutes and then like just parking. And so she did, and it was fine. I just thought that was the thing to do. But yeah, man, I was like half out of a rolling car and like doofus me not even realizing it. So who's got a story about a rollaway vehicle? When has it happened? 1-800-283-101.5.
219, here's Fast Travel.
Seasons Eatings from New Jersey 101.5. How about a delicious holiday with a $50 gift card to Lavoti's Old World Market? Listen for a secret code word, 9 a.m., 2 p.m., and 5 p.m. You enter that on Jersey 101.5 app for your shot at winning the $50 Lavoti's Old World Market gift card. Three winners every weekday. Thanks to Lavoti's Old World Market. That's Monmouth County's premier Italian market and specialty store. Good luck in Seasons Eatings from New Jersey 101.5.
224 with Deminski and Doyle talking about rollaway vehicle stories. Do you have one? 1-800-283-101.5.
And if you have a story, great. And you know what I was just musing on sitting here?
What's that?
Legally, it's still going to be your fault, like if you hit something, obviously. But like, what else could be legally your fault? If you're not actually, like, I mean, it's going to be the driver's fault if they failed to put it in park, unless they could prove like a mechanical failure. But, you know, short of that, if your car rolls into another car, clearly, I guess you're going to get legally charged with creating that accident, right?
Mm-hmm.
What if before it hits that other car, your car rolls through a stop sign, unmanned, and then hits another car? There's no funky point of the law where you could get a ticket for running a stop sign, is there? Like, not if you're not in the car, right?
Well, isn't there a law on not being in control of your car? So I think that would probably trump stop sign.
Which would just be like a separate altogether law.
Right.
Yeah, exactly. But yeah, like legally, I wonder what can happen to you. That part of this I never heard of. Anyway, let's talk to Jack in Glen Rock. You're in New Jersey, 101.5.
Yeah. Hey, man, how you doing?
Boys? How are you?
Listen, I'm fine. It's so funny. This story is in my mind. 1972, 17 years old, hop in my car, leave the house, and my parents' house, it's off the road, main road, off the road, 200 feet off the road.
Uh-huh.
I forget my wallet, turn around, drive back up the driveway. The driveway's up an incline.
Yeah.
Maybe 20, 30 feet, you know, up.
Yep.
I get out of the car, run in the house to get the wallet, and it's a 4-speed on the floor. I get out of the car. It's in neutral, obviously. Come back out, the car is gone.
You didn't put the parking brake on?
No, it was in neutral. No. I'm looking around for this car, and I look down the driveway, and it's on the neighbor's front yard.
Way far away.
What a sinking feeling.
200 feet across the main road, but back 50 years ago, it's not a lot of cars. But,
right.
And I got in the car and just drove it away.
I was going to say, because if it didn't hit a fence, if it didn't hit anything, it just rested on their lawn. Yeah.
No harm, no foul.
Straight driveway up, straight driveway back. Like nothing ever happened. Bounced the curb and nobody knew nothing.
Yeah. They weren't looking out the window. So you were just like kind of whistling and getting in the
exactly.
car.
And nothing to see here.
Yeah, I meant that.
Hey, Jack, thanks for your call.
It just looked like a good place to stop for a moment. No big deal. Yeah, we want to hear your stories if you ever were involved with a vehicle that got away from you in a rollaway.
Teddy in Colonia, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
D&D.
Hey, Teddy.
It happened about, it was in the 80s. We're working on a bridge in Belleville, and my boss goes, listen, supposed to clear up, take the truck over there, talk to the inspector before you guys get out, and they'll make sure you can work. So we go over. It was a stick shift, so we had problems with the starter. Said, I'm shutting it off. Let's just put the parking brake on, go see if he's going to let us work. We walk about, I'd say, a half a block, and it was an incline. He goes, yeah, you guys can work. We turn around. The truck's gone. It rolled down the bridge. Everybody was parked that was working on a bridge on either side. The iron workers, the carpenters, went through everything. Didn't touch not one car except for the portageon on the end. It ran over the
portageon. Oh, what a thing to hit, though. It totally upended the portageon.
Thank God nobody was in it. We ran down there. It was a lot of tidy bowl all over the ground, but it was nobody inside of it. I don't know how we didn't hit any cars that day.
Had you left it, like, obviously the engine is shut down, so you got the parking brake on, but did you also leave it in first and it just popped out?
No, it was in neutral.
Oh, wait. So you let the engine run?
Yeah, it had one of those pull-up parking brakes, and the vibration of the truck, it made the parking brake
down. Oh, no. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got you. Yeah, people that don't know how to drive a stick shift, they don't really get what we're saying, but yeah, I got you.
So the mess from the Port-a-John wasn't too overpowering?
It was, but we stood it back up. It just knocked it up against the fence. It didn't go all the way over. We stood it, but the only thing, I was just saying, oh, man, if somebody's in there, we're in trouble. He's going to hear screaming and get me out of here.
So you guys actually stood there, though, and you, like, you put it back upright?
Yeah, because we had to. We didn't want to get in trouble. We had to still work that day, so... And we probably would have had to use the same port-a-john.
Wasn't everything like sloshing out the door and stuff?
Oh, yeah.
Oh! Teddy.
That's what we're talking about.
Don't you get the rookie guys on the crew to put the thing back?
Sounds like apprentice work.
Exactly.
No, I was the rookie back then.
I see.
All right, Teddy. Thanks for sharing your story with me.
Oh, that's nasty. No, I mean, like, fortunate that it didn't cost him any money. He didn't hit any other vehicles or anything. Oh, yeah, we're talking about this because last night my daughter, who does not have a license yet, she's got the learner's permit, you know. And we went to a couple stores. She was doing her practice driving, and everything was fine except... at the end, she forgot to put it in park, and I didn't notice. Yeah, you know, real good thing to have a licensed driver with you, right?
Yeah.
She's just done this so many times that I wasn't even looking for it anymore. You know what I mean?
You trusted her.
Yeah, because I've seen her do this so many dozens and dozens and dozens of times that I didn't think I had to check that she put it in park.
Mm-hmm.
Clearly, I was wrong. And it started rolling with me half in and half out of the car. Anyway, so who's got a story about a rollaway vehicle? 1-800-283-101.5.
Now the latest New Jersey news.
236 with Deminski and Doyle talking about rollaway vehicles at 1-800-283-101.5.
John on the Turnpike, you're in New Jersey 101.5. How's it going?
Yeah, it's going good. Traffic's pretty good where I am.
Nice. All right. And you're in your car, not chasing it. Yep. This is good.
That's a good thing. Yeah. This story took place many moons ago. I took the farm pickup truck into town to run some errands.
Yeah.
Side note, I just had to switch it from a 3 on the column to a 3 on the floor.
Yeah.
So I got into town. The main street of town is basically a hill, and I parked the car or the truck, and I get out of the truck and I walk partway up, and I'm wondering all of a sudden what the noise is behind me, and I turn around to see that the truck had popped out of gear, rolled down the hill and across the road.
What did it hit?
Into another car.
Oh, it did hit another car.
Yeah.
Oh, that sucks. And this one wasn't even your fault. I mean, like, you did put it in gear, but it popped out.
Yeah, well, that's where I learned that that's why you put your tires towards the curb.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That.
If I had put my tires towards the curb, it would have been all right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'd teach you that in driver's ed.
Yep.
All right, John, thanks for your call.
I will say this for my daughter.
What's that?
Well, she was able to get the car under control without breaking any mirrors off the car.
Okay.
There are guys that I know.
All right.
I'm just saying.
Had to work in a little dig.
I'm just saying, I've known a guy or two.
Yeah, I had a roll away and I went running after it and tried to stop it by grabbing the side view mirror and it came off. All right? I did that. I'm a doofus, all right?
Whenever I hear the concept of rollaway vehicles, though, your story is always the one that pops up first in my head.
Me too.
But, yeah, I'm sure. But what sucks about this, and of course, you know what they say about hindsight, but you would never know this at the time. The thing of it is had Bill not done anything and just watched it, the way his car rolled, it turned out it would have been fine anyway.
There was a small curb and then a berm, and it just stopped.
Right.
Didn't go out in the road, didn't go anywhere.
Right.
Just hopped in and drove it back to where it needed to go.
So it would have been better off had he not even ran towards
it. Yes, it would have been. Had I not reacted at all, the car would have been in one piece.
Okay, but all of your friends that were in that parking lot waiting for you when you pulled up,
Yes. They
have a story for life.
Oh, they always thought it was hilarious.
Oh, they still think about that, man. You may have not seen these guys in 30 years, but they're still thinking about it.
Probably. Mike in Pennsylvania, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hey, guys, how you doing? This goes back a couple of years. I had a couple of American flags that needed to be disposed of, so I pulled into a local funeral parlor that accepts flags for disposal.
Mm-hmm.
And I was driving a new company car. It was one of the. It was a Jeep that had that automatic shutoff when you stop. So I pull into the driveway, get out of the car to put the flags in the bin, turn around, my car's not there. I run down to the driveway, look to the right, it's not on the street. I turn to the left, and I see it rolling through the garage door of the funeral home.
Oh no. Did it hit a hearse?
No, luckily the garage was empty, but it went all the way through and pinned against the back wall.
Yikes. What do you do at that point? I mean, you just have to own up to it, obviously. It's not like you ran, but like...
No. I mean, the funeral director came out. I told him what happened. I called my boss, and my boss said, "You were doing what?" I said, "I was on my way home from an appointment, and I stopped to dispose of flags."
Right, you were doing it the proper way, right, which is nice.
Yeah, so he got a good chuckle out of it. So it turned out it was all good.
See, did you still have them take the flags?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. They
did. Yeah. See, like, I'd feel so sheepish. I'd feel like, I guess forget these flags now.
I'll burn them myself.
Exactly.
All right, Mike. Thanks for calling New Jersey 101.5.
Yeah, that's the awkward part. Like, hey, can you still do me this favor, even though I caused all this havoc? We're talking about rollaway car or rollaway vehicle stories, if it ever happened to you. 1-800-283-101.5.
Anne Marie in East Brunswick. You're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hi. Yeah, this happened when I was in my 20s, long time ago. And I had a Monte Carlo that my dad had given me. And I had parked it in front of the house. I was going somewhere. I started it up. And the door was still open on the driver's side. And I had forgotten something in the house. So I slammed it into park, so I thought, but I didn't.
Didn't quite take it?
No. And I left the door open. I ran up to the house. My mom was standing in the glass door mirror, the glass door.
Mm-hmm.
And as I'm running up to the house to go grab what I needed because I was running late to where I was going, I could see the look on her face. And I turned around, and the car is like rolling across the road, but it's going in the circular motion like a C. And it rolled up onto the across the street, the neighbor's driveway. I start booking. I just started running, and it rolled onto their front lawn. Somehow I caught up with it and jumped into it because the door was open.
Yeah.
and slammed on the brake right before, like a foot before it hit the front porch of the neighbor's
house. Wow. Nice. Nice save.
My mom's in the doorway laughing hysterical, and I'm like, what are you laughing? I never saw you run so fast. You look so funny.
Oh, the adrenaline must have just been crazy. And how old were you? You were pretty young, you said?
Yeah, I was only like 21.
Yeah. Yeah, good thing you weren't 41 trying that move.
Oh, God, no. My dad, we used to give all us kids his cars. He would squeeze every last mile out of them and then give the cars to us kids, and then they would only last a couple of miles, and then they would... like seize up because he was a mechanic. He knew how to get a car to squeeze every last mile out of it. And this car was ready to go, but
now I know you blame the car. Hey, Anne Marie, I know you spared the neighbor's porch, but were there tire tread marks all over their lawn or not even?
I don't remember. I'm sure there probably was, but I just like booked out of there. I just, went and went on my way.
Like, you never talked to the neighbor about it? You never said, hey, here's what almost happened?
No. That's the same neighbor that I backed into their car, too.
Oh, my God. So you were real popular.
I was about to go tell them that, you know.
Yeah, they would have thought it was personal.
Yeah.
This girl just doesn't like us.
All right, Anne-Marie, thanks for your call.
All right, we're talking about times when a vehicle got away from you. 1-800-283-101.5. Hey, we're still doing the Feel Better Bear collection with the New Jersey State PBA. Your gift of a new teddy bear, these Feel Better Bears, they're called, can help a child feel better in an emergency when the police officer can give them a bear to hug. To find your closest Feel Better Bear drop-off location or to buy a bear online, visit our app or nj1015.com. Big thanks to our sponsors, All American Auto Group, Rob Dukansky of RE/MAX First Advantage, and Trinity Rehab. This holiday, give a child a Feel Better Bear. And thanks from all of us at New Jersey 101.5.
251, Deminski and Doyle talking about rollaways.
Jim in Manalapan, you're in New Jersey 101.5. Hey, Jim.
Hey, how you doing?
Okay.
Good. So I work for a company with a big brown truck. Just don't want to mention it. So one day I was delivering, I parked on a steep driveway, and the truck, I'm not kidding you, this is 2019, truck was from 1986 manual, and I parked it, I was in the back of the truck grabbing the package, and it felt it moving.
Oh my God.
Down the driveway, as I'm in the back, ran to the front, hit the brakes, skidded down his whole driveway, this poor guy's left marks on his whole driveway. And stopped right before I hit the bottom of the road. And then the homeowner comes running out like, are you okay? Because he's seen me every day for, like, months.
Right.
And then, so I luckily stopped and I called my boss. And they just go, well, just deal with it.
Wait, you called your boss and what?
They said, deal with it.
Deal with it.
Deal with it? Deal with it?
Deal it.
How about get this thing fixed? How about get me a new truck?
Yeah, no, then my piss bottle also spilt on the back.
Oh, yeah, we can't use that.
Oh, yeah.
All right, Jim, thanks for your call.
Language. Oh, yeah, but that's scary, man. Mm-hmm. Something that size. And if you're in the far back end, I'm not sure if the door was open or not yet, but like if the back door was open, I don't know. If you're like right by that. Do you like just swing around and like save yourself, or do you run the length of it to get to the brake? But obviously he did it right, man.
Barbara in Clementon, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hi. So I was driving home from Atlantic City one night. It was late, like 1:30. Me and my husband, I was falling asleep driving. So my husband said, "Pull over, I'll drive." So I pulled over and I was pretty out of it. I didn't put the car in park. I went to get out of the car, and I couldn't plant my feet on the ground. I couldn't figure out why I couldn't get my feet to get my balance and put my feet on the ground. I was half on the seat, half off the seat. And my husband said, the car's rolling. Put the brake on. I said, I can't. I couldn't get back on the seat, and I couldn't get out of the car. So he ran around the side of the
car. Oh, my God, that's a problem. Really?
Yeah, he ran around the side of the car, yanked me out of the car.
While it's still rolling?
Yeah, the car was still rolling.
Yeah?
I ended up sitting on the line between the shoulder and the highway.
Where did the car go?
He ran after it, and he caught it before it went down into, you know, like a ditch. But
And he's the one who stopped it.
He came back. Yeah, he stopped it. He was able to stop it.
So safe to say he's the athletic one in the couple.
Yes.
Barbara.
Anyway, what happened is when I fell down, I landed on my leg, and he came back to get me. He's like, get up. You're going to get hit by a car. I said, I can't. I think my leg is broken.
Oh
my God. Was it?
So here it was. My leg was broken, yes.
Oh, my God.
Well, that took a turn.
He had to help me up and help me around the other side of the car, but luckily I wasn't smashed on the Atlantic City Expressway. Somebody hit me.
What a nightmare.
Yeah, the broken leg sucks.
Barbara, I'm sorry.
Barbara, thanks for calling New Jersey 101.5.
JC in Clinton, you're in New Jersey 101.5. Hey, JC, we have less than a minute.
Hi, thank you for taking my call. Happy holidays. My husband thought he could stop the van. He was backing it up with materials in it, a white van, very heavy. All of a sudden, he didn't put it in park. It started rolling down the hill. He thought he could jump back in it to stop it. Nope, the door kind of closed on him. And all of a sudden, he ended up in the bushes. Couldn't find him for a while. The van ended up in the neighbor's driveway.
Wait, so
he wound up in the bushes and the van wound up in the neighbor's driveway?
Driveway, and what stopped him was a pile of wood. And the neighbors are like, are you okay? And I'm like, wait a minute, driveway, van. It's not in the driveway. What's going on here?
Yeah, it's all disorienting. Yeah, and then, at some point you got to wonder, did he go underneath the bottom of the, is he like under there?
Yeah. All right.
He's missing, man.
JC, thanks for calling. New Jersey 101.5. New Jersey Chime Time is 3:10 with Deminski and Doyle. I'm Bill Doyle.
And I'm Jeff Deminski, 1-800-283-101.5. Okay, you heard our own Jenner Solo talking about this in her news. This was also on NJ.com. The one piece of information about this story about the teen driver speeding in the Tesla that's missing, for whatever reason, the authorities weren't saying just how young these juveniles were. They're saying they were underage. They're saying they were juveniles. And if you didn't quite catch the story, a teenager was speeding, all according to authorities, in a Tesla Model X. Let's go back a couple days ago, and the EV goes off-road, hits a tree. Three of the four juvenile passengers end up with serious injuries. And anyway, all of them reported as juveniles. The driver and passengers not identified because of their ages, and those ages were not released by the prosecutor's office. I don't know why they wouldn't, but they didn't. And on top of that, driver had to be released into the custody of a guardian and the other people as well, you know, after processing, of course. But all I could think when I saw this was this kid even supposed to be driving? That's what I was, because this happens so much. And I'm not just talking about some crazy, you know, troubled gang kid who's 14 or 15 and stealing cars. I don't mean that. It doesn't even have to be illegal other than the driving before you have a license. I mean in total milquetoast suburban New Jersey to the rural Sussex County to urban areas like Camden. People underage drive cars all the time. So much so that I feel like I'm the only one who never did it. Like, I'm the only one who never had the spine to steal dad's car. And I want to know who did it. Who drove underage? You had no business. You maybe didn't even have your learner's permit yet, let alone a driver's license. You had no idea how to even drive a car. And yet you thought, how hard can it be? That's what blows my mind about this. Before anybody taught me how to drive, like when I'm 13, 14, it would not even have been a thought in my head. You know what I should do? When dad's deep asleep, I know where he keeps his keys. I should swipe his car. Didn't even occur to me to do that. Like, I didn't even think about it and then dismiss it as being too risky. I just had no reason to believe I would know how to do it. And yet countless people will tell you these stories, and I want to hear your stories if you ever did it. So many people will tell you, yeah, they drove underage. Yeah, they took it easy at first. Yeah, they only went in the, you know, local streets. They made it. Mom never found out. Or maybe they did. Might be an even more entertaining story. But who's got a driving underage story? 1-800-283-101.5.
I drove underage, but it wasn't mom and dad's car. It was this girl, and she took her dad's car and drove over and picked me up and then wanted me to drive. And I don't know, I was 14 or 15 maybe, and I had never driven before.
But I said, you're like, hey, I'm here for the potential sex.
Exactly. If I can score with this girl, sure, I'll drive.
Right. I thought you were trying to get me in the back seat. Hey.
So I drove. And I actually drove and got gas, filled the gas tank. I actually didn't fill it. I think we put like $2 in.
Right.
And drove home. I mean, no adventures, really.
But hung out with her.
Uh-huh.
Hey, that's, at that age, that's still hot. Especially with the whole bad boy thing of driving a car you're not supposed to be driving. What time of day or night was this?
It was pretty late at night. And
like moms and dads asleep and you'd sneak out?
Yeah.
Nice.
Didn't run into any cops.
Right. Okay, now see, even that blows my mind, because other than some video games, you never did this before.
Nope.
Had you admitted to her, or did you not want to admit to her?
No, I admitted to her. I'd never driven before. She goes, well, neither have I, so you drive. I said, okay.
Gotcha. How far, you probably don't remember, but if you do, how far was it for her to get to your house?
A lot farther than I drove.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So
all right, so she had skin in the game.
She did, yeah. She had driven farther than I did.
Right. And here's where else I'm impressed. And no, I'm not saying that kids should do this, all right? You shouldn't do this, okay? Back off, lawyers. But I'm impressed not only you had the balls at like 14 to drive this car you never drove before, but you also stopped for gas?
We needed to.
And you didn't grow up at that point in your life. You were not in New Jersey.
Nope.
So you pumped the gas yourself.
I sure did.
Had you ever done that for your dad?
Yes.
Oh, okay. All right. So that wasn't, gotcha. That wasn't like a crazy feat.
No.
Okay. At least
I was familiar with the process.
But yet lining the car up, driving it for the first time.
Not hitting the gas pump.
Yeah, exactly. That can be a little intimidating.
Yeah, I was a little nervous.
Like, I mean, I told you last hour, I'm teaching my daughter how to drive, you know? And like, you know, I'm making her do things like drive up to a drive-through ATM where you got to get real close and stuff. Yeah, it's intimidating when you haven't actually done that before. Mm-hmm. All right, so, yeah, man, I swear, whenever this comes up, it feels like I'm the only one who never did it. Did you ever drive underage? 1-800-283-101.5.
John in Sayreville, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hey, guys. How you doing today?
Hi, John.
Hey.
Definitely. I actually stole my friend's father's car because I didn't have the cojones to steal, like, my dad's car.
Hey.
And because I was tall enough to reach the gas pedal.
Because you were the taller one? Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, he had, a Ford LTD. Like, I don't know if you remember these things.
I do.
They were,
I do.
It was, like, this huge station wagon.
My buddy had one, yeah.
He was, like, 4'9", and I was, like, actually, like 5'6", 5'7".
Nice.
So I was just tall enough to reach the gas and the brake pedal.
Yep.
And we drove from Tom's River up to Madison Square Garden to go see Twisted Sister and Dokken in concert, and,
Come on.
You drove from Tom's River to MSG?
Yes.
You drove in New York City. You drove in New York City.
Well, I drove just to get to the parking garage. That was like on top of Madison.
I don't care. Still.
I was afraid to drive anywhere else.
Still. That's amazing.
Yeah. Well, what was amazing is we didn't get caught until I told my dad when I was 21. And he's like, if I saw you sneaking in the house again, I would have beat your, you know what.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And you were how old? You said 14?
I was 14, yeah. I was I was tall for my age, so it was the only reason why we were able to pull it off.
But you drove on the parkway, no problem?
Parkway, no problem. No, it's like, it was like, I mean, there was no cameras or anything at the time. So
you paid the tolls?
Yeah, paid the tolls and just kept going. I mean, we stopped for gas on the way back, but I mean, it's in the middle of the night, you know. Ain't no one looking at you funny like in the middle of the night, so.
Like Jake and Elwood out there, the freaking Blues Brothers.
Wow. All right, John, thanks for calling New Jersey 101.5.
See, I never even thought about driving around Union County Park and going back home. Never even thought about it.
He drove into the city.
Right. Wow. Right.
I think we're all impressed by that.
That's amazing. All right. Not a competition, but did you ever drive a car underage you had no business driving? 1-800-283-101.5.
318, New Jersey Fast Traffic. New Jersey 101.5 wants to light up your holidays with $1,000 in cash. Send us a picture of your home's dazzling holiday lights to our app or nj1015.com. Your entry gets you in to win $1,000. Thanks to our sponsor, Seasonal World, New Jersey's favorite Christmas store and in-ground pool builder. This holiday, light it up. You can win $1,000 from New Jersey 101.5.
3:23 is the time, and there's this story making news. I'm really not sure if this was maybe like a 17-year-old who did have a license or not. The cops aren't saying. But it resulted in a crash. There were some serious injuries. No deaths, though. No fatalities. But it was a teenage driver, underage. That's all we know. And I'm just kind of wondering if the driver of this Tesla didn't even have a license yet, because this does happen all the time. This one happened in Bergen County. But, you know, suffice to say, we want to know, have you ever done that? Did you ever do that thing where you were bold enough to drive a car underage, whether it was a buddy's parents' car, your brother's, you swiped your mom's car when she was asleep? 1-800-283-101.5.
Don in North Carolina, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Good afternoon, guys.
Hi, Don.
Hey. Now, North Carolina, they start driving at 5, right?
I'm only driving through. I'm from New Jersey.
No, okay. Yeah. I just wanted to get that in.
I started driving at 15. I taught myself to drive stick, and because my family was in the construction business, we always had lots of extra vehicles around. So I would routinely take a car and go out and do whatever I had to do. And one morning, I actually passed my father on the road while driving one of his cars.
Oh, my.
Okay, now, did he know that you used to do this, or was it all behind their backs?
Well, he had an idea, because obviously, you know, gas gauges and things of that nature, but
it was never with his blessing, put it that way.
Right, and there were times he explicitly told me, do not drive the cars.
Oh, so he kind of knew. All right, so the day that you passed him in his own car, he saw you, I'm assuming.
Yeah, well, he was driving past me going the other way. We were going to different places.
Right.
I was going out to Dunkin' Donuts to get myself breakfast.
Right.
So when he came home later...
Don, did we lose you?
So
when he came home, what?
He just kind of shook his head. I said... When he came home, he said, I told you not to drive. And I said, well, there was nothing to eat in the house for breakfast, so I had to go to Dunkin' Donuts. And he just kind of shook his head.
Yeah, it was an emergency.
I had to, Dad.
And I'm sure it was more like, there's nothing in the house to eat that I felt like eating.
Yeah. All right, Don, thanks for your call.
Yeah, I'm sorry, man. Dunkin' is never really quite an emergency. I mean, it feels like it, but not quite.
Chelsea in Middletown, or in Milltown, I'm sorry. You're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hi, how are you?
Fine, thanks.
Hey, Chelsea, welcome.
Hello. I have two stories of underage driving, okay. Unfortunately.
Okay. Both of that, right. That you did?
Yes.
Wow.
Well, the first one I was allowed to. I was 14. My uncle was visiting from California with his two kids, and they were only like 4 and 1.
Yeah.
We were driving... A car he rented, it was a 2001 Mitsubishi Eclipse convertible, so I felt so cool in it.
Right.
And he just randomly stopped the car and swapped seats and let me drive the car over a huge bridge somewhere in New Jersey. I don't know where. It was 20 years ago, but it was
awesome. Did he have to talk you into it, or were you totally eager?
No. Oh, no. I was like, oh, yeah, I was scared, but he was, like, kind of insistent. He was like, try it out.
And the little kids were in the car?
They were, yeah.
Oh, my God.
I know.
Did your parents find out that your uncle did this?
I don't remember.
Yeah, I
might have told my mom, but
oh,
I don't,
no
I
way.
Really don't remember.
Oh, I bet you not a chance if you didn't tell. I don't think he did. All right, so what was the other one?
So I was in high school. I was maybe 16. I don't remember if I had, I think I had my learner's permit at the time.
Okay.
I was cutting school at home. I took my mom's, well, it used to be my great grandmother's 1982 Buick LeSabre.
Nice.
Also, yeah, it was also baby blue. It was gorgeous. I drove it for a while, but I took it and drove around somewhere, like just around the corner, around the neighborhood, and my mom's coworker happened to be on lunch picking up chilies, and we turned the corner at the same time, and she looked at me like, girl,
yeah.
And like, as soon as I got home, my phone rang, and it was my mom, and she was like, what are you doing? Where are you? I was like,
Busted.
I don't know. I was a little reckless back then, but I didn't go on the highway. We were just kind of around the corner.
Oh, wow. Hey, yeah. As long as you don't go on a highway.
Well, that's okay then.
Yeah.
All right, Chelsea, thanks for sharing your stories with us.
It was only semi-illegal. You know, if I'm the friend at work, I'm not sure what I'm going to do.
Yeah, that's kind of a ethical dilemma, isn't it?
Right. Because I understand, even at my age, I still understand being a teenager, even though I didn't do this thing, but I did a lot of other dumb things.
And as a parent, would you want to know that your child was doing it?
Yeah, like I would, but I don't know. I don't know if I would narc the kid out. I'm just not sure.
Peter in Chatham, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hi, can you hear me?
Yes, Peter.
Yeah, you're good.
Okay, so I guess this is back in the early 70s. My father used to go to work at like 5 o'clock in the morning, which means he was home by 3 o'clock in the afternoon taking a nap. So I would just sneak into his room and very carefully and quietly pick up his keys. Then I would go after the car. I put the car in neutral and push it out into the street so he wouldn't hear me. So he wouldn't hear it start.
Mm-hmm. Right,
and,
right.
In the middle of the street, I just started the car and I used to drive all over town.
And I'm sorry, how old were you, did you say?
I was probably 15, maybe.
And you sound like you did this all the time.
I did it not a lot. I think I probably did it maybe 10 times. I guess that's a lot.
The very first time you did it, what made you think you would know how to operate a car?
You know something? I mean, let's face it, it's not brain surgery. And I only stayed on side streets. I never went on the highway. You know, I probably drove from my house over to the high school and around, but it was always side streets. And actually, when I look back on it, you know, how dumb can I be? Because if I had an accident or hurt somebody, I mean, that is serious stuff.
Oh, of course.
Yeah, as an adult, you realize that.
Right.
As a 15-year-old, you don't care.
Right.
All right, Peter, thanks for your call.
But that's the attitude most people that did this. I was like, it's not brain surgery.
Mm-hmm.
I'm thinking most of you would have tried brain surgery too. I'll be honest with you. All right, we're talking about driving a car when you're not supposed to be. You don't even have a license yet. You're that young. Who's done it? 1-800-283-101.5.
Now the latest New Jersey news.
This is New Jersey's radio station, New Jersey 101.5. And here in the Garden State, obviously, when you're 16, you can start learning to drive, but you gotta, you know, you can only drive certain hours. You have to have that licensed driver with you. But what about before 16, man?
Mm-hmm.
You got no legal business being behind the wheel.
But it's tempting.
Did you ever do it? Bill's done it. Everybody calling in has done it. Not me. 1-800-283-101.5.
Phil in Manville, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hi, how are you? All right. My name's Phil.
Hi, Phil.
Hey.
Good. I just want to share a story with you. In 1975, I was in vocational school, auto body class. And it was the middle of January, and the teacher was out sick. He was ill for a bit. Anyway, somebody got the idea. I don't think it was mine, but opened up the garage doors and took all the cars out and just started cruising around.
Nice. And you were how old? Obviously, this is before you were licensed.
15.
15 years old. Well, you know, you were already working on them, right?
We were already working on them, and I guess the thought was, if you put a scratch or a dent, we're an auto body shop. It's all good.
Wow, nice. That's a great point,
that
man.
Is.
Yeah, I got to be honest with you. Like, I wouldn't be, like, if I were your dad back then, I don't know how outraged I could be, because it's like, well, this guy can, like, practically build them. Like, who am I to say that he can't operate one? Mm-hmm. He can do everything else with one.
It was a different era back then, too. You got to realize most young people around that age or even earlier knew how to drive. Today, kids don't even want their license, it seems. It's just kind of weird.
A lot of people don't.
Yeah, it's weird. That's a fine point. There have been whole articles written on this in news media that people are waiting years sometimes before even trying to get a driver's license.
Phil, thanks for your call.
I mean, that was it, man. You counted down the days, and then when you got that license, didn't your parents not see you all evening?
Yeah, I took the car and there you go.
You were gone, man. And even if it was nowhere to go but just cruising the roads, that's what you did.
Terry in Lawrence Harbor, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Yes, hi guys. How you doing?
Okay.
Yes, I was 16 and I purchased my sister's car. And I was backing it back and forth in the driveway and ramming out gas. And so I tapped the school bus gas tanks to fill it up. And one night, me and my friend took a ride. Yeah, I know. One night, me and my friend
You're
took
an outlaw.
A ride to see our girlfriends.
Uh-huh.
And we left them, and we're driving down this road. And I was doing 60 on this road. And the friend goes, 60, is that all you're doing? So I thought he meant to go faster, so that's what I did. I saw a sign that said 20 mile an hour curve.
Oh my God, dude.
I looked at him and I said, uh-oh. I took down 150 feet of guardrail, went over the side of the road, stopped squarely at a tree, him and I survived. I had a broken nose, 13 stitches. But we walked from there 2 miles to the police station to report it.
How much trouble did you get in?
Believe it or not, nothing. All I had to do was pay for the guardrail. And back then, around 1968, it was about $1 a foot.
Wow.
I had to pay $150 for the repair of the guardrail.
But you were doing this without a driver's license.
Correct.
And they were like, just pay for the guardrail. We'll call it a wash. You paid your price.
And that was pretty much it, except for, the trouble I got in with my parents.
Yeah. Well, plus the girlfriends. You never showed up.
thankfully, they weren't in the car.
Yeah, really.
All right, Terry, thanks for your call.
Man, oh, man. Paul in Nutley, you're in New Jersey, 101.5.
Yes, another 15-year-old story. I grew up in the Maryland suburbs of D.C., and one night I snuck out of my bedroom door, took my parents' brand-new Cadillac, picked a friend up. We're driving through the red light district of Washington, D.C., and a prostitute knocked on the window, and I panicked, and she fell over and started chasing the car. The police saw it. I ended up having a high-speed chase with police through D.C., and then my parents got a call in the middle of the night. Their 15-year-old, who they thought was downstairs, safe in bed, was in the police station after having a high-speed police chase.
After apparently looking like he was picking up a prostitute. Time of your life, eh, kid?
Yeah, really.
Wow. Holy risky business.
I also got off with nothing, and when the cops kind of got a kick out of me, and when my parents came in, they were yucking it up with me and arm wrestling me.
The cops were, yeah.
Yeah.
Your parents were taking it more seriously.
Yeah.
Wow.
What now?
A hooker and a high-speed chase all in one night.
Go back to that moment with the prostitute. What exactly happened that panicked and she fell over? How did she fall over?
Intersection where, and I wasn't trying to pick one up or anything. I just panicked when she knocked at the window to try to solicit me, and I floored.
And she kind of goes flying away.
She was fine, but she was mad at me for, making her fall.
Right.
Police saw it, and then they started chasing me.
I gotcha.
Panicked. Yeah.
I gotcha. At least that's what we'll go with.
Yeah.
That's the story we'll go with.
All right, Paul, thanks for your call.
Yeah, man. Were you ever in an area that had like the really low level street prostitutes?
I don't believe I've ever seen a hooker.
The only time, I've seen them in New York, but as far as like actually being approached by one, only time was in Northeast Philadelphia around like Frankfurt section. Mm-hmm. They would just walk up to you and it would be 9 o'clock in the morning. You would never think hookers would be out at 9 o'clock in the freaking morning. They were. They would walk right up, and it was summer, no air conditioning in my car, had to have the windows down. And I remember this real skanky, low-level street hooker, probably like for $5, and just like leans right in through the window at a red light. Didn't even look at her, didn't want to be talking to her, just leans right in and says, "You want a date?" It's like, oh, my God, get away from me. I feel like I'm getting a disease just looking at you. Oh, God.
But 9 in the morning, you have to admire her work ethic.
1-800-283-101.5.
352 with Deminski and Doyle. News coming up at the top of the hour. And right now we're talking about driving underage at 1-800-283-101.5.
Sean in Plainfield, you're on New Jersey, 101.5.
Hey, guys. How you doing?
Hey, Sean.
Hey.
I was 15 at the time, and I took my mom's car out, and I drove to school for an entire week while she was away on a business trip.
Never got caught?
What?
Nope. Not until she got home, and I nicked her car when I was backing in the garage.
Oh. Okay, but how did you drive it to school, and nobody at school notices that this kid's showing up in a car?
Because all my friends were driving, and they were like, "Wow!" They was like, "You got your license?" I was like, "No." They was like, "Well, how'd you get her car?" I said, "Well, I made a copy of the key." So when she went away, I just took the car and drove.
You even did that?
Yeah.
You legit swiped the key and made a copy of it.
Yep.
Oh, my God, man. And you almost got away with it if it weren't for that one nick.
All right, Sean, thanks for your call.
Glenn in Livingston, you're in New Jersey, 101.5.
Hey, how you doing, guys?
All right, Glenn.
Hey, Glenn, what's up?
Hey, I was 13 at the time, and I was cutting my uncle's grass. You know, every week I would go there and cut the grass. And I just stopped off with a friend of mine. It was a small lawn, so I took care of it real quick. And I was a little thirsty, so we went to the refrigerator. We saw some Heineken, you know, and we ended up starting drinking some Heineken.
Well, wait, where's your uncle at this point? He's just away?
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah. Yeah, he's away. He went to Barbados.
Okay. Okay. So you help yourself at 13 to some Heineken.
Yeah. I just helped myself to some Heineken. And, you know, then we just, after three of those, I saw, you know, I was like, hey, his car keys are here. He had this, like, big old Buick. It was like a Mack truck, you know. And I said, hey, let's go take a little ride around the neighborhood here, you know. So we did that. You know, but we ended up getting caught, you know, because I was driving a little erratically because I had three Heinekens in me at 13, you know, and, you know, they ended up catching us, arrested us, you know, and we did a couple of days in the North Youth House for it.
Oh, really?
Oh, this is actually
a price to pay.
Yeah, man. Oh, but it was fun. It was great because we had a little chase. Yeah, man, we had a little chase going on. You know, my buddy.
Ran from the cops before they caught up with you?
Yes. Oh, yeah. Dude. We saw them, and then we were out of there.
Okay, but well, how was how was juvie prison for a few days?
It was a little different, you know. It was a little different, but it wasn't terrible.
It's supposed to be terrible. The idea is it terrible so that you don't do it again.
13 years old, swiping beers, swiping cars, running from the cops.
And then they put him up at a Sheraton, apparently.
Yeah. All right, Glenn, thanks for your call. Thanks for listening to New Jersey 101.5.
Hey, the holidays are here. Are you finding yourself running around but still dragging through your days with that nasty pain, the bad back, the stiff neck, whatever's been bothering you? Maybe to the point that you can't even decorate the whole house the way you wanted to. You're dreading having the kids or the grandkids over as far as like playing with them on the floor and all that. You're worried you can't do it. You might need physical therapy. And let me tell you, if that sounds like a downer, Trinity Rehab is not like other physical therapists. No prescription needed to get started. Same day appointments possible. Fast results. Because Trinity has a lot of technology that the other physical therapists simply don't normally have. Call Trinity at 800-518-0977. Online, you'll find them at trinity-rehab.com. Ask about their EPAT therapy. This is cutting-edge stuff. It's acoustic pressure wave therapy. The majority of people using this, it works so fast. The majority see big results in only three short five-minute sessions. And Trinity is now in network with Aetna. That might help you out. They have dozens of locations in New Jersey and Pennsylvania. Brand new ones just opened up in Piscataway and Summers Point. There's going to be one near you. For more info, trinity-rehab.com. New Jersey Chime Time. It is 4:10 on this Friday Eve. It's a Thursday afternoon. We are D&D. Deminski and Doyle. I'm Jeff Deminski.
And I'm Bill Doyle.
There's a couple of stories, actually, not just one. Eric Scott has a big write-up on this, why New Jersey schools should start classes later.
Mm-hmm.
And this would affect so many things, by the way. If you don't have kids anywhere near that age, still stop and hear us out about this. Because a lot of people say, well, if you have high school classes start later, there's only so many buses to go around. And now it's going to mean that elementary school classes would start earlier. And then that's also going to mean that they're going to get out sooner, the younger kids. Mm-hmm. So if you got younger kids, this could still impact you.
Mm-hmm.
So don't think this is, well, that's 10 years away from me. I don't care. Well, no, this could mean you, because if they normally get, say, off a bus at 4 o'clock, what are you going to do if they start getting off a bus at like 2:35?
Mm-hmm.
As far as like who's going to watch them, right. You know?
It's a dilemma.
Right. Things like this. But Eric Scott has a full write-up on this and how state lawmakers, they have been poised to tackle this for like a year now. But it just keeps stalling out. This just, it's right there and it just does not seem to get traction.
But at the same time that that this is making news, specifically in Homedale, this is yet another high school on its own, not being told by the state that it's got to do it. They are on the brink of making their high school start 40 minutes later. What they want to do is starting next September, and the school board is looking to do this, but it's not, you know, absolutely carved in stone yet. But they would like to move the start time 40 minutes later. Right now, it's 7:20 in the morning. That's when classes start.
Mm-hmm.
The start time would become 8 a.m. And what they are talking about doing is interesting, because they had not heard this offered up before. Instead of just pushing everything then to them getting out that same amount of time later, they're talking about shaving just a few short minutes off of each period, like three.
Hmm.
They say that there are six class periods throughout the day. Shorten those by roughly 3 minutes each, and it's going to work out to right around about 20 minutes.
Okay.
And so the dismissal time, instead of being 40 minutes off, it would only be half that time off. It wouldn't be that big of a deal,
mm-hmm.
and it would be less impactful that way. And when you think about it...
It's pretty shrewd.
Right? And all, right. I was going to say, when you think about it, all the times that this has come up, never really heard them talk about this idea before. It was always like, well, yeah, but now they're going to be, you know, getting out of school an hour later.
Mm-hmm.
Does it have to be that way? Because I'll tell you what, they have to legally get in their 180 days, right? But as far as what constitutes a day, look at all the times they have professional development. Well, maybe that's a bad example because sometimes those are full days off. But look at the times they will have any sort of early dismissal. Those will still count as full days,
mm-hmm.
at any grade level. If you're getting out at, you know, 1:20 instead of 3:30, that's still considered a full day. Legally, 20 minutes less, that will still be a full day. And also, by the time you reach the high school level, if you shaved only 3 minutes off per class session,
mm-hmm.
you would think that the students by that age should certainly be old enough, mature enough to handle the responsibility of getting right to work, no screwing around, whereas middle school, intermediate, elementary school, maybe they do need more hours for a class.
Mm-hmm.
But high school, now they ought to be able to handle that,
I think.
Right? Yeah, exactly. So I was thinking that this could be a good solution. But with this popping up back in the news, we want to know at 1-800-283-101.5, think of any facet of this you want to. Do you think that high school ought to start later in the day? 1-800-283-101.5.
You know, the research says it should, that the body clock for the people going through puberty, the teenagers, is just different from little kids and adults. So if you want to accommodate that and have them learn better, then that's the way to do it. And isn't that the outcome you want? You want them to learn more, to be more receptive to education. And if that's accomplished by starting later, then why not do it?
A lot of people feel like you're coddling kids. I don't. I agree with you. It's just that we've learned things over the years,
mm-hmm.
you know? And the National Education Association, they can show you figures that show nearly a 5% increase in exam grades among students with a later high school start time.
Well, that's noticeable.
Right. That's the only difference, apparently. The only difference is what time of day they're starting. And yeah, that much of an improvement in grades right there alone. And so they also say, by the way, in Eric Scott's article, that you know, many parents are actually in support of this now. A poll conducted by Fairleigh Dickinson University February of just this year showed wide support for a later school start time in New Jersey. 55% agreed that school start times ought to be later. Only 30% were opposed. And if you never heard this before, by the way, I mean, this has been talked about for a while, but hey, you can't catch everything. You're busy. I get it. Sometimes you're working three jobs, for God's sakes. I get that. Research over the years has shown, and it's not trying to coddle kids, it's just like neurological, you know, research. The brain at those ages, when you are entering those teen years through high school, and it doesn't stay that way, but for those few years of the high school age, the brain in a human being, it is meant to be more, not of a fully nocturnal creature, but it is meant to be awake later at night and sleep later in the morning,
mm-hmm,
for it to be at its prime. This is not just a matter of, like, we always used to just chalk it up to lazy teenagers.
Right.
Falling asleep at their desk. Lazy teenagers. That's what everybody assumed. And then the science started looking at it. And it wasn't just one or two crackpot studies. There have been study after study after study on this. And it keeps coming up and pointing to the same thing. There is a difference. And the brain then changes back. By the time they're about getting into their college years, maybe freshman year might be a little tough, but, you know, by second year of college, now it's when they can start getting up early again and be fully functional. But there is a weird thing that happens, and it's been too proven to just keep ignoring this, and I think they're right. And as a result of all that study, all that research, the legislation that keeps getting stalled in New Jersey calls for no high school to be allowed to start before 8:30 a.m. Because that's what all the science is showing, is that optimal, no high school ought to start any sooner than 8:30. Mm-hmm. And so that's what the legislation reflects. And other things might have to give, though. So, you know, as a taxpayer, as somebody whose kids might do sports, as maybe somebody whose kids is in a, you know, lower grades, not even in high school yet, whatever. Where do you stand on that? Do you think that New Jersey high schools ought to be forced to start later in the day? 1-800-283-101.5.
418, New Jersey Fast Traffic.
Every holiday season, New Jersey 101.5 collects teddy bears with the New Jersey State PBA. Feel Better Bears, they're called. Give a gift of a teddy bear, and you can help a child feel better during emergencies when the police give them a bear to hug. Find your closest Feel Better Bear drop-off location or to buy a bear online just by visiting our app or NJ1015.com. Big thanks to All American Auto Group, Rob Dukansky of REMAX First Advantage, and Trinity Rehab. This holiday, give a child a Feel Better Bear, and thanks from everyone at New Jersey 101.5.
424 with Deminski and Doyle, talking about starting high school later in the day to give those people in the high school age, apparently their clocks are a little different and they need to get up a little later. And the science is proving that, and New Jersey school districts are looking into it.
Yeah, more and more. Homedale might be doing this. And if you want to read more about it, Eric Scott, as I said, has a story on it on NJ1015.com. But where do you come down on this?
Emily from Morris County. You're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hi, thanks for taking my call, guys.
Mm-hmm.
So I was a product of this. I went to a county vocational school. So my school, high school, was 9 to 3:30. And it was really not great. I couldn't play sports. I couldn't have a job. Like most workplaces, if they close at 9 or 10, you're not able to make a 4-hour shift, and nobody will hire you for less than that. I'm sure, I mean, a lot of those struggles are relative to, like, the infrastructure and all the timing of sports and things like
right.
that have to be done to make it work.
Right.
But
it was because of other things. It wasn't necessarily that you weren't more rested or that it wasn't better, you know, academically for your vo-tech school. But it was the way it would impact these other things for you was a problem.
Yeah, it was like secondary struggles, I guess. You know, I couldn't make it to the football games after school with my friends and things like that. So it would have to be like really a widespread solution. And then I think, you know, everyone would hate it for a year or two. By the third or fourth year, we'd all forget that it happened. If it really was done across all of these, if all the trickles were resolved first.
Yeah, I mean, as far as like the game being what time it would have been back when you did it, I kind of have to wonder if it was across the board by New Jersey law that all high schools had to start later. Would games also then be pushed later and you could have done more of those extracurriculars? Now, the job thing, I don't know. I'm not just... I can't solve everything. I can't even solve this. But I mean, I guess I'm just saying, because only a handful of schools were trying it when Emily did it, I think it was probably more problematic than it might be if everybody were on the same page doing it.
True. All right, Emily, we appreciate your call.
And again, a study on this, or I should say a poll on this, it came out with that the majority of New Jerseyans have heard this long enough, I guess, that they now support the idea. But do you personally support the idea of a kid being able to sleep in later and start high school in New Jersey no earlier than 8:30? 1-800-283-101.5.
Phil in Wall, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
So I have a friend who's an administrator in a district up north where they're looking at this, and there's a lot of obstacles that I don't think are being taken into consideration.
Yeah, let us know what you know.
Sure. Most of the districts have tiered busing, which means that there are three different, the buses run and they drop off the little kids and the middle schoolers and then the high schoolers. So if you're going to do something like this, it means you're going to need more buses, which is at a cost, millions of dollars. In addition to that, there's a national shortage on bus drivers. So who's going to drive the buses, even if you attempted to do this? In addition to that, because you have the tiered busing, you also, someone has to be out earlier. If you're saying the high school students are going to start later, and if you do tiered busing, that means the younger kids are mm-hmm. going to have to be at the bus stops, especially in the winter
mm-hmm.
when it's dark. So now the question is, would you rather have a high school student sitting at a bus stop waiting to get to school when it's dark at 7 o'clock, 7:15 in the morning,
mm-hmm.
or a 5-year-old? So there, you know, there's certainly studies that show that there's a benefit. But
well,
does the benefit outweigh the costs and what we're talking about potentially happening?
Okay. Well, in Homedale, the way they have it structured, they said it's not going to cost anything extra. But, and I know what you're saying, for most districts, if they had to add extra busing, obviously that's going to be a problem. But since it's tiered busing, and you kind of already answered this by saying, like, well, what if you just switch and the 5-year-olds are going to have to be out there when the high schoolers would have normally been out there? If you just switch all the scheduling around, then you will not have to hire more bus drivers. You won't have to buy more buses. But is it a problem for the 5-year-old to be up that early? I don't think as much as we think it is, because, A, their parents are going to be with them. Nobody's having a 5-year-old wait at the bus stop alone,
mm-hmm.
okay? So the parents are going to be there. They might even be actually warm and toasty in the car, just park there waiting for the bus to pull up.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I'm not really going to be thinking that they're going to be freezing. And as far as the child actually being able to be up that early, we all remember our kids growing up. It's like on a Saturday or a Sunday morning, the younger the kid, they were up and ready to go, man.
Way too early.
Right. It's when they're in middle school and high school that they're sleeping in. And so, yeah, if anything, it would make more sense. My opinion, just giving you my opinion, it would make more sense for elementary school kids to actually be the ones to start at 7:30 in the morning because they're ready.
All right, Phil, we appreciate your call. We appreciate what you had to bring to the table.
I think the bigger issue, as long as they could work out those schedules and so they don't have to hire more bus drivers and buy more buses, I think the bigger issue is going to be, are parents going to have a hard time, not in the morning, but at the end of the school day, if the elementary younger kids have to get home earlier?
Mm-hmm.
And then who's
going to watch them?
Exactly, right. Maybe you've got some neighbor that watches them for the 45 minutes now until you get home or something. Well, what if it's like now, you know, an hour and a half, an hour and 45? That, I think, might be the bigger problem. Of all of these things, in fact, I think that might be the biggest thing. But it probably doesn't get talked about as much as, like, extracurriculars. All right, so what do you think? There's a story by Eric Scott on this. This is why New Jersey schools should start class later. And they're talking high schools. What do you think? 1-800-283-101.5. New Jersey, 101.5. You know, when I was in high school, I don't remember ever actually being one of those kids that, like, fell asleep at my desk.
Mm-hmm.
But I think I was lucky. Because, I mean, I saw it. I saw it all the time. And this is before it was really studied widely. So, I mean, I think even other kids just assumed, yeah, you're staying up too late, man.
Out partying.
Right, you're right. And it's really not all that. And a lot of people assume, a lot of people assume that because kids today, you know, they got the devices, they've got the laptops, they've got the smartphones and everything, and that they're just wasting time instead of going to sleep by screwing around, instead of realizing maybe it's the other way around, maybe they're on those things because they have tried sleeping, can't
mm-hmm.
finally get up out of bed, do something for 12 minutes and then give it another shot. I know my own son Jack was like that. And he was a good student, man. He's a straight A student, mm-hmm. but he had a hell of a time. He definitely was one of these kids that would have been in one of these studies. So we want to know, do you think that high school start times in New Jersey are too early and should be moved later, even if it takes the legislature to force the schools to do it?
Glenn in Tom's River, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Well, my thought is that it's never too early to get ready for being a young adult. So I would suggest that you kind of emulate what it's going to be when you're a young adult. High schoolers, I would say 8 to 4, and for grammar school, middle school, 9 to 3. That would allow the bus drivers to do a run, come back, and then pick up the younger students.
And the 8 to 4 would actually be a later start for a lot of schools.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of schools are starting as early as, like, say, 7:10 in the morning.
When I was in high school, I actually had to take 3 buses to get to school. It took. I lived in Lake Apacon. They didn't have a high school built at that time, so I had to go up to Sparta. It took my father less time to drive from Lake Apacon to Jersey City to go to work than it did for me
wow.
to get from Lake Apacon.
What a waste of time.
Yeah. Yeah, but I mean,
had a rendezvous with the second bus. Sometimes it was there, sometimes it wasn't. Then I got dropped off at a elementary school up in Sparta to wait for the third bus. You couldn't even go into the school because you were not
part of that school.
That school.
Yeah.
You were allowed just to stand outside on the steps waiting for that third bus to pick you up.
But you know, you probably could have done better work in school if you didn't have to go through all that, right?
I think I did well. It certainly made me I guess maybe a better person for, you know, having to persevere and
tougher
and put up with it.
Yeah, I mean there's always going to be that theory here with kids, like, well, you know, when you get into the real world, just in a few years, you're going to have to be up whenever the boss says that's the start time of the day. But I don't know. Again, it's like once you realize that you're actually fighting human biology,
yeah.
I think that's the difference.
By the time it's time to get out in the workforce, your clock will be different.
Right. And if you want to say, well, you know, it's never too early to get, well, yeah, it is. You going to do that with a 5-year-old?
Yeah.
You going to make a 5-year-old put in 10-hour days in kindergarten? I don't think you will, because there are certain things that are age appropriate. And I'm not trying to coddle kids. I'm really not one of those parents. But
they still have to go to the same amount, the same number of hours.
Right. And we're just saying, if there's a way to get the same amount out of everybody without it making, you know, all the rest of society somehow crumble, why not do it? And I'm not the first person to say this. I think in times we talked about this, Bill was the first to ever point this out. But one of the worst reasons for doing anything is simply because it's how we always have done it.
Yeah.
If you learn a better way, then go for it.
Katie in Freehold, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
My daughter is a junior at a Catholic high school uh-huh. in Monmouth County. And she takes her classes each semester typical to a college where she's taking only 4 classes a day plus her lunch period. Her classes are a little bit longer, but because of that, she goes into school about half an hour after our homeschool does. So her school day is only 6 hours, including lunch, is 6 hours and 19 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
So she could, you know, if they wanted to do something like that, they could do it where they could start at 8:30 and go to like 2:30, you know, 2:45, if they adapted to that type of a schedule.
If they just structured things a bit differently.
Correct.
Yeah. Yeah, so you're not saying no to this. You see yeah. some wisdom to what they're saying here.
I do. For me, it wouldn't work if they did it that way, because we take my son has to go to school around the same time as her, and he goes to school near her. For our transportation issues, it wouldn't be ideal for us, but I could see where, you know, a high school kid, I mean, she works a full-time job, a job when she gets out of school, and she comes home from her job around 10 o'clock at night, and that's when she starts her homework. So she's up doing homework till like midnight.
Yikes. Yeah.
And then next morning to go to school.
That's a lot.
Yeah, that's arduous. All right. Mm-hmm. Katie, we appreciate your call.
Beatrice on the Parkway, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hey, how are you guys?
Okay.
Hey.
So the only thing is, like, I see definitely where you guys are coming from, but they do it that way with the timing, how they stagger it because of transportation, because of the buses.
I know.
So they have to have all those buses available now. Okay, you did the high school, they go, and then they go immediately and start their middle school run. And then, again, the elementary school kids.
Well, couldn't you just swap?
Yeah, that's what we're saying, though. We know that. You're right. Like, why not just have the elementary school kids start early?
Oh, like they go at 7? Start at 7?
Yeah, because kids that age, they're generally up and full of energy then. They're ready to work.
Yeah, but kids that age need, like they say, like 8 to 12 hours of sleep instead of just 6 to 8 or whatever. You know, the younger kids.
Well, the adolescents do, too. But all right, Beatrice, we appreciate your call.
Yeah, well, they can get it and still be up earlier and easier than a lot of the high school kids can.
So what do you think about starting high school later in New Jersey? 1-800-283-101.5.
So, you know, making ends meet around the holidays can be tough, especially when you're in need of home repair and improvement projects. And you shouldn't have to make a choice between gift giving and critical home repairs. And you know who knows that and understands that? It's the company that I've been talking about that does all kinds of home improvements, PJ Fitzpatrick. Good people here. And PJ Fitzpatrick understands, and they have secured no interest financing programs up to 25 months for qualified buyers for everything from new windows, new showers, even a new roof. If it's a dire need, this is the place to go. Visit them online at trustpj.com for more information. That's trustpj.com. This holiday, bring on the bling. You could win a free pair of diamond stud earrings from Earth Treasures Fine Jewelers. It's the perfect holiday gift and worth over $5,000. This is the last week you can enter to win on our app or nj1015.com. Thanks to our sponsor, Earth Treasures Fine Jewelers, the area expert for almost 50 years in Eatontown. This year, make it sparkle with Holiday Bling in New Jersey 101.5.
4:52 with Deminski and Doyle. News coming up at the top of the hour.
Hey, I just saw an update, by the way, and we spent an hour, was it just yesterday?
Yeah.
I guess, talking about celebrity deaths because of Andre Brower.
Mm-hmm.
Andre Brower, you might remember him more from Brooklyn Nine-Nine. You might have just seen him around South Orange because for many years he was a New Jersey resident.
Mm-hmm.
He's done performances here. Brilliant actor. The thing that I always remember about Andre Brower, though, is the character he played on Homicide, Life on the Streets. It was about a... It was a TV show that ran on NBC for years, but they never did great in the ratings, but it was like one of those that like the critics loved it.
Yes.
You know? And yeah, very critically acclaimed. He won Emmys for it and everything. But he played Frank Pembleton, a homicide detective. And he passed away at only age 61. And when it came out the other day that Andre Brower had died, all that their publicist was saying, all that the family was saying was after a brief illness.
Mm-hmm.
That's all that was being said. Well, now it's come out what that brief illness was. And this is always so sad. Only a few short months ago, he found out that he had lung cancer. And so he was dealing with that, I'm assuming battling lung cancer for just a couple of months. But sometimes lung cancer, by the time they find it, it's just so advanced, it will just take you that quickly.
Yeah.
And I guess it was one of these cases. But what's really sad, though, is in the New York Times, in New York Times Magazine back in 2014, so I mean, this goes almost a decade ago already, he had said at that point in an interview that he had stopped drinking alcohol and smoking years before that.
Sometimes it catches up with you anyway.
That's exactly it. This is one of these things where maybe Andre Brower, you know, smoked, drank when he was in his 20s and 30s, didn't do it anymore. And all those years later, 61, and then it shows up. I mean, that's how insidious lung cancer can be. It can be like 25 years after you stop smoking.
Yeah.
So obviously it's always better to never even start. But oh my God, what a sad thing. And you know what else he was in too, by the way? People don't remember this much, but he was in the movie Glory with Denzel Washington and Morgan Freeman.
Never seen it.
He was. Oh, you never saw Glory?
I've never seen Glory.
Oh yeah, such a great film. Yeah, just one of the finest actors you're ever going to find. And yeah, man, just what a loss.
Mm-hmm.
And New Jersey's loss too. Like I said, he was a South Orange guy, not born and raised. He was from Chicago, but he lived here for many, many years. Anyway, we've got news coming up. New Jersey, 101.5.
On that radio.
New Jersey Chime Time, 5:09 with Deminski and Doyle. I'm
Big Bill Doyle.
You're more like a game show host.
My name's Jeff.
It's Jefe, man.
The choice of New Jersey alcoholics.
We're just some guys from Jersey.
You get a chance every day to talk about New Jersey.
You wouldn't understand. It's a Jersey thing.
The mighty kingdom of New Jersey.
You're from Jersey.
1-800-283-101.5. By the way, a little thing that the station likes to call NJ1015.com, the radio station's website. Bill and I have several stories that are up right now that you might want to look at. One of them is this came up when we were talking about how I took back the DoorDash tip.
Yeah.
Right? And we did a whole thing on that.
Mm-hmm.
And I was looking up some things about tipping, and I came across a stat that shocked me. Did you know, according to some figures, New Jersey is among the worst tipping states in America?
No kidding.
I'm not sure I believe it, but it's got the methodology and everything there. If you want to check. Oh, dude.
I wonder why.
We're like in the bottom 10.
Really?
We're bad.
Is that cheap?
Put it this way. We're tied with Arkansas. You wouldn't think you're going to make great tips in Arkansas.
You wouldn't think
right?
so.
Exactly. I don't know if it's true, but you guys can check it out for yourselves and see what you make of it. I was shocked. Also, now this is not official, like from Social Security Administration, because the year's not even out yet. But outside of an official source, probably the best unofficial source is that Baby Center website.
Yeah,
and they've got what they believe are the biggest baby names of this year gone by as mm-hmm. it comes to an end. And there's a new number one. But what's also cool about this piece is that it gives a lot of trending names that you're not going to get really from Social Security. And you know what's big right now?
William.
No, not even close. Cutesy little three-letter names are big. Like Teo or Jay. Anything with three letters.
Huh.
Those are big. And also nicknames as the legal full name. Like William is out. Bill legally would be in.
Huh.
Yep.
William usually does pretty well.
I'm not so sure about that anymore. Especially not nationally. It's nowhere near the top 10, man. You know, okay, here's a crazy one. You know what they say? A number, I think it was number 9? Ezra.
Really? Ezra's making a comeback?
Yes. Ezra?
Huh.
Are you kidding me? How many Ezras are you meeting? But apparently in 20 years,
you will be.
That's exactly it. Apparently in 20 years, you're going to be meeting a ton. All right, and then this one. You guys got to check out Bill's story. I don't even want to give it away. I'm so disgusted by this. I don't even want to give it away. And I don't want to have an argument about it. But think about what in your mind would probably be New Jersey's favorite Christmas movie.
Yeah.
And then check out the correct answer.
Oh, yeah.
Right
on the nose.
Nah. There's no way this could be true.
100% correct.
Ah. I'm dying to talk about it, but maybe tomorrow. Maybe we'll let people take a look at this, and maybe it'll be something that we can talk about
tomorrow. And it changed from last year.
Yeah, so look for that. This is New Jersey's favorite Christmas movie, and I say it ought to have parentheses going, really? Really?
Yes, really.
Bill supports it.
Absolutely.
I don't know that I do. Anyway, that and Kylie, by the way, on her own page, Kylie Moore,
mm-hmm.
On her own page, she's got some really cool photos of not far from where she lives, these houses on a certain street in Freehold. They are so done up for Christmas. They look like they're professionally done. I mean, absolutely jaw-dropping gorgeous. And she's got a ton of photos that she took herself.
Cool.
Yeah, so that's up as well. All of that and more on NJ1015.com.
The internet, that thing's still around.
All right, well, that's all the time we got today. No. We're kidding. All right, you know how sometimes they get you to like a certain product and then they take it away from you, they yank it away?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Like, what were those things back when Joe V worked with us and he moved on now?
Oh, those
Dunkaroos?
Is that the dip and stick things?
Yes.
He was so excited when they brought him back.
He was so excited when they brought back Dunkaroos, man, because they were discontinued for years. And I can't remember if it was a limited time or if they're still back, but they brought back Dunkaroos. And then he went and he got them. And then I remember this crestfallen look on his face. And the way I remember it, I could be wrong, but I remember it like he refused to really admit publicly that they weren't all that good. Like, I think they were better in his memory than they were as he was retrying them all these years later.
Yeah, I just remember him going to 7-Eleven like a excited little schoolgirl.
Exactly. Like, just bring in the back bay like the armloads. I know. You're right. Well, anyway, there's a couple of these products that are making news because they are coming back. One is from Taco Bell. Another is from McDonald's. Now, don't get too excited, because personally, I never even remember these products. So maybe you will be excited. Maybe this is a big thing to you. Taco Bell announced that it is bringing back something called the Double Decker Taco, but it's only for the holiday season, so it's for a limited time. It's a take on a traditional taco. It takes a hard taco shell filled with, beef, cheddar, cheese. Basically, it's a freaking taco, okay? Yeah. You can upgrade your double-decker taco by throwing in tomato, sour cream, blah, blah, blah. And they're also going to have this double-decker supreme. But they say that it almost made a return to their Taco Bell menus back in 2022 after it was listed among several items for the public to vote on. That the public wanted to make a comeback. But the Enchirito edged it out. And so the double-decker taco went into obscurity. But now, the double-decker taco is currently available at select locations throughout the U.S. And again, they're not saying when it's going to disappear. All they're trying to get at is during the holiday season. So just another cheesy way to get you to drive through.
Yeah, and if it's that popular, why only a limited time? They think they can only sell a few of them. And if they think they can sell a lot of them, they're going to keep them on the menu.
Right. Exactly. So I don't get it. I don't get this constant game that fast food does. But here's the other one. McDonald's. I never had one of these. Maybe I shouldn't have said I don't remember hearing of it. Maybe I heard of it. I just never had one of these. 7 years after McDonald's discontinued snack wraps, the menu item is making a comeback.
Yes, I've never had a snack wrap.
Yeah, like I think I may have heard of it, but let's see. McDonald's president Joe Erlinger is announcing the menu items will return under a new name as part of the fast food chain's McCrispy line. So it's going to be what they call a McCrispy snack wrap. The McCrispy will be offered in McDonald's markets around the world by 2025. Will include everything from tenders to snack wraps, new menu items in the line, blah, blah, blah. The original snack wraps had a chicken, lettuce, sauce, yada, yada, yada. So, they're bringing back snack wraps.
Okay.
Except you got to throw the word McCrispy in front of the snack wrap. And that's what's new. But apparently you got to wait a year. I don't know. I don't know why.
Yeah, why announce it a year in advance?
Yeah, I don't know. How is that going to get? I mean, maybe it's going to be just like a slow, long, painful rollout. Maybe here in the U.S. it'll be here by like next month. I just don't know. All I know is they always announce these things like it was a fan favorite. Okay. What were the real fan favorites? If there was something, and it doesn't have to be fast food whatsoever, this could be any kind of product. Doesn't have to be even food. It could be anything. But what is a product that was discontinued that you would love to see make a comeback? What do you want brought back on store shelves or menus? 1-800-283-101.5.
518, here's fast traffic. 524, Deminski and Doyle, talking about products that were discontinued that just broke your heart. You wish they would bring them back. The 1-800-283-101.5.
By the way, if you ever experienced the pain, even if it was only a one-time thing, one product years ago, but man, you were disappointed that they didn't make it anymore, you have a very sympathetic ear in Mr. Bill Doyle here. He's the king of trying to push companies to get products to be brought back to market.
And searching everywhere to find them.
He once called the Campbell's Soup Company in Camden. This is not, I'm not making this up.
Mm-hmm.
He got on the phone. He got some worker on the phone. And do you remember what type of soup it was? Do you remember which one? Because I know there were several that they stopped.
It was red beans and rice with sausage.
That's what. And Bill's like, yeah. Put me through to whoever's in charge of red beans with rice and sausage. I mean, okay, it's not exactly like that.
But I talked to a very friendly woman.
Right. And he's like, why'd you discontinue it?
Do you have any laying around?
Right, that's what he's trying to convince her. There's got to be like some in a warehouse somewhere.
Yeah, can you go look?
I could come down right now.
I could. I'm in New Jersey. I'll come pick it up.
Like, I'm not making any of this part up. I'm making up the tone, okay? But I'm not making up that he had this employee. And he's like politely grilling her. No, really. I can come down right to the warehouse. Just keep it for me. I'll pay for it.
Mm-hmm.
And she, like, how did that end? Did
she was
like,
very polite about it and just pretty much told me to F off.
Get help. Sir, I just can't do that.
Yeah. She was polite but not helpful.
Right. So you got a very sympathetic ear here is the point. All right, what is some kind of product that they took away off the market and you really wish it would make a comeback? 1-800-283-101.5.
Neil in Wall Township, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hey, how you doing?
All right.
Hey, Neil.
Hey, so there was an iced tea called Honest Tea, and I used to drink the green tea, which was great, and it was, you know, it's good for you and not a lot of sugar in it. And Coca-Cola bought it about 3 years ago, and then a year later, they discontinued it.
Oh.
And you got to wonder, like, did they just, like, buy it to discontinue it?
Yeah, sounds like it, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, wait a second. I just looked this up. I haven't read it yet, though, but the headline says, Honest Tea founder may have good news for grieving fans. But this was from January of this year. Decision made. But, yeah, I mean, you got all this right. Coca-Cola, they bought it out. But it sounds like there was maybe some kind of talk that maybe it would be brought back. But the article's too damn long to read on the air.
TLDR.
Yeah, the guy who founded it started another company and they make it and you have to go to Whole Foods to get it.
Oh, that's what it is. But the formula doesn't seem the same.
Yeah, it's all right. Yeah.
But it's not quite the same. Okay. All right. Yeah. He was one step ahead of me there.
All right, Neil. Thanks for your call.
Let's try and help him out.
Yeah.
Let's try and help him on the fly, you know?
Nice of you.
Yeah.
Michael and Tom's River. You're on New Jersey 101.5.
What's up, boys?
Hey, Michael.
Mine, it's kind of, I don't think you probably ever heard of it. It was around for a very limited time, but I think it was General Mills. Whoever makes Cinnamon Toast Crunch, they made Peanut Butter Toast Crunch. And if you're a peanut butter lover, it was like the greatest thing ever.
Yeah.
And they haven't had it for like 10 years, but every time I'm at the supermarket, I still look for it. Like, just in case one day they bring it back.
How long was it out?
It was out for a couple of years, and they discontinued it once and then brought it back. And then they just flat out discontinued it again, and I haven't seen it. But I know it's like earlier, maybe like 2007, 2008, around that time.
Mm-hmm.
It's been a while, but it was really, really good.
Have you thought about calling the company?
No, but I think you're going to be my inspiration.
Well, would you like to leave your information and have Bill make these calls for you?
I don't mind.
Yeah, sure. Tell him to send it to my house.
All right, Michael. Thanks for your call.
Okay. Talk about like a weirdo losing business plan. You launch a company, a little cottage industry, right? No one else is doing it, where you find clients and you only get paid if you can get their product to be brought back to market.
Yeah.
And they tell you what they miss, and then you hound the company and try to do a social media blitz to get them to bring it back.
Might turn it over to my wife. Remember when we got the thing for Christmas and the game didn't work?
Uh-huh.
And she called them and wrote them a letter and said, you ruined Christmas. And
right.
They sent us a new one.
Right.
So, yeah, that complaining works.
She's tenacious. She's
a bulldog.
She's probably better at it than you are. Right. You can just be like the CEO, but like she'll like do all the grunt work.
Okay. That suits me well.
There you go. All right, hey, how's that peanut butter toast crunch account coming? 1-800-283-101.5.
Melanie and Deal, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hi.
Hi, Melanie.
Hey, what is a product they took away from you that hurt you?
A Butoni instant pizza.
Whoa.
Did you ever have it?
No, it's what? Instant Butoni's?
It was Butoni instant pizza, and it was encased in a shell, not real hard. You put it in the toaster oven. I used to keep like 6 boxes in my refrigerator because when my daughters would come home from school, that's what they wanted. And then all of a sudden they told their friends, well, I fed their friends. I mean,
okay. I just looked this up. It looked almost like... If anybody knows what like a crunch wrap would look like from Taco Bell,
okay.
Like all encased, I think that's a crunch wrap.
Yep.
Yeah, it looks kind of like that. It's like all encased with the pizza stuff inside. And did you know, you're not alone, Melanie, because did you know there's apparently a community group on Facebook named Please Bring Back Butoni's Instant Pizza.
Well, guess what? I'm going to join.
Yeah, I bet you will.
They have 6,700 followers.
Nice.
Yep.
Add Melanie to the list. All right, Melanie, thanks for your call.
And over 6,000 likes. Wonder how long they've been at this campaign, though. This has the first entry I see when I scroll down.
Yeah.
This page has been blocked by Butoni USA.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Oh, those cowards.
Shills. Rat bastards. All right. We want to know who's ever had any kind of product, whatever. It's often food. It doesn't have to be, though. Any kind of product that they took off the market and you would love to see it make a comeback. 1-800-283-101.5. New Jersey 101.5. By the way, still to come. I don't know how you feel about this if you're a small business person. Or if you just already know you're not getting a raise in January, but the minimum wage is going up. So people beneath you are getting a raise. Minimum wage is going up to $15.13 an hour. We'll talk about that because now your governor is saying, that's not enough. It's like he finally wanted this. He finally got what he wanted, the $15 an hour. Now he's saying, no, ought to be higher. We'll talk about that later on. In the meantime, a couple of products, they are bringing them back, at least temporarily anyway. Snack wraps from McDonald's, this double-decker taco from Taco Bell. What is a product, food or otherwise, that was taken off the market maybe even years ago, and you still wish they would bring it back? 1-800-283-101.5.
Angela in Union, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hi, guys. So good to see you, to talk to you again.
Hey, Angela. How are you?
Good. I actually had 2 products. It was a cereal cranberry almond from Pathmark, and it was like ever since Stop and Shop bought Pathmark, they got rid of the cereal, and I was looking high and low for it, and I can't find it.
Cranberry almond?
Yeah, it's like a cranberry almond crunch.
Way too healthy.
Right.
Way too healthy.
A company called Get Well. I'm not even sure if that was a Pathmark brand or another brand. I have no idea.
Wait, like Get Well is a brand of a cereal?
Yes, it was. And I don't even know if it exists anymore. I actually just tried to look it up. I'm like, it's like it never existed. I'm so disappointed.
Was it for sick people?
No, you can actually buy it in the store.
You're way too healthy for me. Jeez. You like do Pilates and stuff, don't you?
I don't. I wish I did. I love those people. I'm so jealous.
Oh, all right.
What was your other product?
Well, the other product was Breyers Cookies and Cream. No one believes me. In the early
Okay, there you go. Now we can get along.
They had a cookies and cream that tasted like a dark chocolate. And I actually called them on it. And they said, oh, no, our recipe hasn't changed for years. I said, yes, it did. Because it used to be like these little dark chocolate nuggets.
And now they actually use Oreo. And I'm like, no, I don't want the Oreo. I want your dark chocolate nuggets. And they say, oh, we can send you a coupon. And I'm like, that's not the same.
Yeah, well, it's like a coupon for what? For more of what you don't want, right?
Exactly. I don't have anything against Oreo. I love it. But the way their cookies and cream are so different from every other brand, that dark chocolate made it so delicious. Oh, my.
Okay, Angela, you I mean, this is great. You really did. You actually called. You got a number somehow, and you called the customer service line.
I absolutely did.
Good for you.
They were really sad that they could not help me, and they offered me coupons.
Could you tell that it was just somebody who probably had only been there 3 months, was reading off a 3x5 card, and really had no idea if they did or did not ever change the recipe?
Absolutely. It was definitely just a customer service rep, not anyone with the last name Breyers.
Where's Breyer? Get him on the phone, or her. I don't want to be sexist.
Funny. All right, Angela, thanks for calling New Jersey 101.5. Call the company. That's a woman after my own heart.
Yeah, I mean, you don't have to have taken it so far that you joined the Facebook community group or actually called the company. But if you did, oh, bonus points to you if you were that bothered when they took a product away. But what is something that was just so good? It was either like a product that worked so well or a food product that tasted so good, whatever the circumstance, and they discontinued it. And man, you would still, even years later, love to have it brought back. What is that one for you? Or several. 1-800-283-101.5.
Cherry M&Ms. Cherry M&Ms were out, I don't even know how long. Not long enough. And then they just disappeared. And I look for them. I look for them on Amazon. They don't exist. Now, my son works near Times Square by the M&M store.
Yeah.
And he said they have a Black Forest cherry M&M at that store, but it's not the same.
Did he get it for you?
He did, yeah.
Okay, and it just doesn't taste the same.
Yeah, I mean, they're good. They're not as good as those cherry M&Ms were.
Right. Well, can I tell you something? Not to dilute what we're talking about, not to derail it, but they've really made far too many types of M&Ms.
They haven't made enough.
No. You know why? You know why I know this?
Why?
It certainly couldn't be because I'm just stupid and wasn't paying attention. I had to buy a bag of M&Ms because of a gingerbread making project for my little boy, right? And I had to send it into his school, and I had to get the graham crackers, and I had to get the miniature candy canes, and that was even ordeal, finding the mini ones, and I had to get the M&Ms. Well, they wanted only the red and green M&Ms. Only the red and green M&Ms. Now, you would think only a bag of red and green M&Ms this time of year would be easy to find, right?
Holiday special.
Right? Three stores, Bill.
Yeah?
Three different stores. Maybe they just were like getting cleaned off the shelves. Three freaking stores I went to, cannot find red and green. Finally, I'm at the third store. I'm like, I can't help it. I'm just going to get a gigundous bag of all the color M&Ms, just like the regular color M&Ms. There's plenty of green and red in there. And if they really don't want any other colors, then they can just pick through, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I finally get that. I mean, I really tried. I get a note from the school through the Class Dojo,
a
little online app thing, right? Yeah, if you remember, we have class allergies here. I don't know if you meant to do this, but you sent in the peanut butter M&Ms.
Oh.
I didn't notice.
Yeah,
I didn't notice.
You can't do that.
I was so focused on the freaking color. They're making two GD many different types of M&Ms,
They make s'mores M&Ms. Espresso M&Ms.
Right.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. It's too many.
They're too much.
No,
they're delicious.
Just calm down, everybody. All right, we're talking about products that were taken off the market, and maybe to this day you miss them. What would you love to see brought back? 1-800-283-101.5.
As the weather gets colder, the NFL offers stay hot on FanDuel. Right now, new customers get $150 in bonus bets with any winning $5 moneyline bet. That's $150 if your team wins. If you've been thinking about joining FanDuel, there's no better time to get in on the action. The app is so easy to use, even if you're a beginner. You can download the app and place your first bet in just minutes. They have a wide range of betting options for you to choose from, too. They have the same game player props. They have spreads. They have over-unders. All sorts of different betting options. So visit FanDuel.com/Doyle and kick off the NFL season. FanDuel, official partner of the NFL. Must be 21 and older, present in New Jersey. First online real money wager only. $5 pregame moneyline wager required. $10 first deposit required. Bonus issued is non-withdrawable bonus bets that expire 7 days after receipt. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER. New Jersey 101.5 wants to light up your holidays with $1,000 in cash. Send us a picture of your home's dazzling holiday lights to our app or nj1015.com. Your entry gets you in to win $1,000. Thanks to our sponsor, Seasonal World, New Jersey's favorite Christmas store and in-ground pool builder. This holiday, light it up. You can win $1,000 from New Jersey 101.5.
551 news coming up after that. If you're not getting a raise in January, well, we're going to tell you who will be. Also, again, on nj1015.com, Bill's got a story about what is supposed to be New Jersey's favorite Christmas movie.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, take a look at it, because I want to dissect this tomorrow.
Okay.
I want to do a post-mortem on this, because I'm not buying it.
Oh, I am.
Anyway, right now, though, we're talking about products that they took off the market, food or otherwise, you would love to see brought back. 1-800-283-101.5.
Steve in South Plainfield, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hey, guys. How you doing tonight?
All right, Steve.
Hey, Steve.
All right. I was telling Kylie, years and years ago, Hostess used to have a product that I love. They were basically chocolate-covered Twinkies called Chocodiles.
Chocodiles, sure.
Oh, I remember Chocodiles, yeah.
Yeah. Then they tried to bring them back like a few years ago, and they made them smaller, and they changed, and the company got taken over, and they were just no bueno. And now they don't even have any. Now they have nothing. So that's definitely something that's missed.
Huh.
Twinkies themselves came back smaller.
Yeah. Yeah, they were not quite the same.
No, but the Chocodile was definitely great. Back in the old days, the ring-dings, the big wheels, the Chocodiles, all those things.
Yeah. Yeah, when they revamp a thing, it's almost like when they bury it in the pet cemetery in the Stephen King story. It comes back, but it's not quite the same.
It's a little off.
Yeah, it's a little off, yeah. Gauge isn't right.
Steve, thanks for your call.
Eric in Hybrid, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Well, hey, guys, how are you?
Okay, Eric.
I was calling in about a product Hershey used to make. They were called Flips. And if you think of Pringles potato chip, they were just like that. They were shaped like that. They were thin, and they were the best things to use for making s'mores, because as soon as you put them between the marshmallow and the crackers, they melted instantly. So you weren't biting into hard chocolate. They melted really well, and I just thought that would have been such a good campaign for them to sell them, but they didn't last too long.
Was it actually, I'm probably wrong, was it actually like a chip inside that was just chocolate coated?
No.
Or not really? No?
No, it was just like a Pringle, but it was solid chocolate, but it was thin like that, and it was shaped like that. And
all right, but
I don't
just
remember
chocolate,
if they even came in a can. They might have come in a container or something. I don't remember, but they were the best things for s'mores.
Bring back Flips.
Yeah. All right, Eric, thanks for your call.
Excuse me, Rick. Just swallowed a fly. Rick in Freehold, here on New Jersey 101.5. Hey, Rick.
Hey, spit.
thank you, doctor. Thank you.
Yeah. Ham diggers. I grew up in Asbury Park in the late 70s and early 80s, and there was a product called a ham dinger. It was a ham steak, probably mechanically separated.
Oh, that's always appetizing.
We grew up on that. It was breakfast, lunch, dinner. It was versatile. It was great, and I can't find them anymore. I've looked it up, and I've been to Florida. I've been all Virginia, Carolinas. I can't find them. It was great.
Oh, my God. I actually found this on the internet. There's a picture of the old can, ham dingers.
Yeah. It
was, eight fully cooked ham patties.
Ham patties.
Individually with layers of wax paper and everything. They were awesome. I miss them.
Sounds delicious.
you sure?
All right, Rick, thanks for your call.
Just by image alone, man, I'm not so sure about that.
All right, more to come. New Jersey 101.5.
Hey, the holidays are upon us, and maybe you're running around, you're trying to get all the last-minute stuff done. Maybe there were certain decorations you couldn't even get up this year, all because of pain that you were hoping was just going to heal on its own, and it's not, and you finally have that day where you realize, yeah, I need physical therapy, but man, it's going to be drawn out. Not really. Not if you go to the right place. That right place is Trinity Rehab. It's not like other places you've heard of. No prescription needed to get started. Same day appointments and fast results. That's the main thing. Fast results. Because Trinity Rehab has a lot of technology that other physical therapists just don't have. Call them. 800-518-0977. or go to trinity-rehab.com. One thing that is amazing, they have a lot, but one thing, cutting-edge acoustic pressure wave therapy, they call it EPAT. Ask about that. The majority of people who use it see big results in only 3 short 5-minute sessions. Trinity is now in network with Aetna. If that helps you out, they have dozens of locations in New Jersey and Pennsylvania. Brand new ones just opened in Piscataway and Summers Point. More info at trinity-rehab.com. New Jersey Chime Time. It is 6:11. It's a Thursday, and we are D&D. I'm Jeff Deminski.
And I am Bill Doyle.
Hey, we're gonna talk about a certain group of people that are going to be getting a raise. It's the minimum wage. In just a moment. I want to get something out, though, because I just think this is really clever what they did at a legislative hearing. Bill and I, a couple of times, we've talked about how, years ago when they banned smoking in workplaces, and this included bars and restaurants, and all of a sudden in bars you had to do the thing where you went out onto the sidewalk and had your smoke, everybody thought it was going to kill the bar business, and it turned out, no, it didn't. In some cases, it seemed to actually increase business, things like that. Well, when they did that, they had a carve-out for the casinos.
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, they had smoking areas within the casinos. And a lot of times you say, that only does so much. So, you know, like the last battlefront for this whole non-smoking thing, it's been casino workers pushing the politicians in Trenton. How about us? We want to work there, but we continue to worry about breathing in the secondhand smoke, and they want the ban to be extended to casinos. The casino business keeps lobbying, pushing back, because they're worried that the casino, you know, customers are just going to go to, like, Pennsylvania or places where they can smoke.
Right.
Okay. So with that being said, there had been this big push in this lame duck session, and now it's all over. They didn't get it done because the guy pushing the bill didn't have enough votes. That casino lobby came in, pushed back hard enough. They lost some votes, and so they're not putting it up for a vote because they know that they're not going to be there. They say that they're going to take it up again in the new year with some of the new people being sworn in with a new legislature. But all of that to say, you know what happened today at a legislative hearing?
No.
Union leaders and casino workers were in that room, and they were pissed. And so you know what they did?
Oh, did they smoke?
They all pulled out cigarettes and lit up where they're not allowed to, right in the politician's place of work, and they started puffing away.
Nice.
They started puffing away like Dennis Leary, like Cancer Man. Yes, they did that. And one of them says, hey, we're not allowed to smoke in your workplace, right? But you can smoke in our workplace. Oh, that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, just to prove this is how obnoxious this is. This is how unfair this is. And you know what they did?
What?
These cowardly politicians. Well, I mean, I don't know who exactly pulled the trigger on it, but they had them escorted out. They were thrown out.
Oh.
I feel, if they weren't going to have the balls to put this up for a vote, I feel at least, you know what? Let them make their point, because it's actually a damn good one. But nope, they wouldn't even let them do it. They ended up throwing them out. How can you blame them?
That is a great move, though.
Wasn't it? I never once thought of that move. All the times that this keeps coming back and they keep having hearings, mm-hmm, and they finally resorted to, you know what we're going to do? We're all going to light up at a certain, mm-hmm, I mean, that's, seriously, that's inspired.
Blow,
man,
smoke rings at the legislators.
Exactly. Yeah, that's inspired. I freaking love that. All right, enough of my little soapbox. Now, what do you think about this? Governor Murphy, he's glad that we are now at the point on January 1st, minimum wage workers are getting another raise, and it's finally that long-awaited $15 an hour magic mark is finally going to be hit, and it's actually going to be $15.13, because it's the minimum wage, it's not only gone up every year since they passed it in 2019, but it's tied to the inflation rate.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why it's a little bit more. And from here on out, it will still be tied to an inflation rate. So there will still be little bumps and increases, just, you know, not as big. But you know what Murphy said as he's celebrating this? He said, I wonder whether or not we shouldn't be taking this higher. That's something I'm open to. I'm open-minded to taking this to another level. He wants even more. He wants a higher minimum wage than the $15.13 an hour that people are going to be getting now on January 1st. I wonder what most people think about that. We might be at the point, because this was so long in coming, because they broke this in like a dollar an hour per year.
Mm-hmm.
We might be at the point with where prices are that maybe people could see the wisdom of it and have no problem with it. Or maybe if you're a small business person, you've only got a handful of people under you, but you would come under this. Maybe this you feel like would break you. I don't know. But I'm just asking, what do you think? Is $15 an hour enough of a minimum wage in New Jersey? Or should New Jersey's minimum wage go even higher than that? 1-800-283-101.5.
I know one of the arguments in favor of it is that people who are making minimum wage, when they get their money, they don't sit on it. They have to spend it on necessities. And so it gets more money back into the economy.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's one way of stimulating the economy is by raising the minimum wage. Although higher prices will also probably follow.
That's it. I never really know who to listen to here. You know, I'm not necessarily a big fan of it. And also one of the things that I don't like about raising the minimum wage like this is the people who do have a skill set and had come in and they were making, say, $22, $25 an hour. There's nothing to say that they're getting a raise.
Mm-hmm.
And for the last 2 years, let's say you were making $25 an hour, but you haven't gotten a raise in 2 years, and there's tons of people like this, okay? Well, the guy beneath you who just walked in through the door without your experience and without your skill sets, they came in 2 years ago making 13 when you were making 25. Then they were making 14 when you were making 25. Now they're making 15 and 13 cents when you're still making 25.
Mm-hmm.
It's bringing you closer to the base level by you not getting any increase whatsoever. And it's almost like with prices going up, you being stuck, it's almost like you're making less money than you were 2 years ago. And that's a problem. And whenever they raise the minimum wage, I feel like it's hurting those people who aren't exactly rich, but they also have some skills, so they're not coming in at that entry-level market, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know. Where do you stand on that? We want to talk about this minimum wage thing because, again, your governor is saying $15.13 an hour for a state minimum wage. He thinks that we could do better. He thinks maybe it should be higher, and he's clearly going to be looking at that. Should it be more? 1-800-283-101.5.
618, New Jersey Fast Track.
How would you like to have your most delicious holiday ever with a free $50 gift card to Lavoti's Old World Market? Listen for a secret code word at 9 a.m., 2 p.m., and 5 p.m., and then you enter that on the New Jersey 101.5 app for your shot at winning a $50 Lavoti's Old World Market card. There are three winners every weekday thanks to Lavoti's Old World Market. That's Monmouth County's premier Italian market and specialty store. Good luck and season's eatings from New Jersey 101.5.
624 with Deminski and Doyle. New Jersey's minimum wage will be going up in the new year over $15 an hour.
And your governor is saying he honestly is thinking it's not enough. And that's what we want to ask you. Is $15 an hour minimum wage good enough for New Jersey minimum wage? And, you know, I'm not trying to convince you. We just want your opinion one way or the other. But, I mean, I guess I'm old school. I keep going back to originally a minimum wage is designed not to raise a family, not to raise a couple of kids. And I hate when they give those examples of, you know, two working moms and dads earning minimum wage and having two kids to raise. It's like, well, what are you even trying to have kids for when you don't have any job skills yet to earn above minimum wage?
Yeah, if you can't support them, why do it?
Right. So the whole raising a family thing for me is nonsense. There are these things called condoms, man. Use them. So anyway, the governor is saying $15.13 an hour is probably not enough. He is thinking more. And when asked, when pressed on it, you know how much he said?
How much?
Up to $20 an hour.
That's a pretty steep increase.
Right. He said maybe 18 to 20 which in progressive political speak means 20. That's what he would like. Now, again, he's not trying to say, you know, like, let's do it next year. Just like this one came over the course of a couple of years, but now we're here. He's actually, in his mind, targeting $20 an hour as a minimum wage. What do you think of that? 1-800-283-101.5. Is that getting a little ridiculous, or are we at the point in New Jersey with prices that $20 is really not a big deal? That $20 does work out to what, $3.35 back in the early 1980s?
Yeah, they do point out that it hasn't really kept pace with inflation, the minimum wage.
Mm-hmm.
But now that it's supposed to, now it's tied to inflation, right?
Right. It's tied to it. But now he wants to go above that. And see, is that okay? I don't know how small businesses really dealt with this. I mean, if you work for a small company, when these minimum wage hikes kept hitting, did they start just getting more part-timers, save money elsewhere? Did they start cutting back on hours? Because this was always what opponents of this said would happen.
Mm-hmm.
But you don't hear a lot about it. So we want to know. I mean, maybe everybody is actually at peace with this. Maybe everybody is fine with the $15.13 an hour. But would you be with 20? Is that going to be okay with you? Can you absorb that as a small company? 1-800-283-101.5. And perhaps I am wrong, but I don't believe that I worked for minimum wage, and I'm guessing most people, and this is where I'm saying maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm wrong that most people didn't work minimum wage jobs since they were like teenagers.
Mm-hmm.
But those are the jobs, it seems, would pay minimum wage. And then later on, you've got some working experience. You basically learn how to show up, how to be on time, how to follow some orders. You prove to yourself, okay, we're giving you 25, we're giving you 50 cents more. This is back in the day, I mean. And those jobs, they didn't seem worth $15 an hour. Like, if you're working in a fast food joint right now, is your job truly worth what he's talking about, 20 bucks an hour? How is it? When you can just walk in there right at 15 or 16 years old, first job in one of your first years in high school, and you're going to get $20 an hour is what Murphy's talking about. How is it worth that? I don't get it.
And you brought up a good point earlier. What if the assistant manager was making $20 an hour, you know, because he had worked his way up? Now, all of a sudden, everybody coming in is going to make the exact same as he or she does. Even after their years of experience, it doesn't seem quite fair.
No, it really does not. It does not. So we would love to have your opinion on this. What do you think about the minimum wage? Not only about it where it is now, the 15 an hour, it's going there on January 1st, but Murphy is hinting around he would like to see it at $20 an hour. 20 bucks an hour for a New Jersey State minimum wage. Is that a little ridiculous, or could you actually see it? Also, would love to talk about this. What were your minimum wage jobs when you were a kid? Think back when you were only able to earn minimum wage, those first couple of jobs out, what were you doing for a living? Because, I mean, I think that proponents of these minimum wage hikes would have you people thinking that, you know, you're working for Johnson & Johnson in research and development and you're only making $15.13 an hour.
I was a dishwasher making minimum wage.
Right, exactly. These are the kinds of jobs, like jobs that you can get in off the street, no experience. Let's see how you work out for 6 months. Then we'll talk about a raise. These are the jobs that I think, by and large, even today, I know they try to screw some older people who are out of work, things like that. But generally speaking, I think that still holds. So what were some of those jobs that you had as a teenager where you were making minimum wage? And should it really be 20 bucks an hour? 1-800-283-101.5.
636 with Deminski and Doyle, talking about the minimum wage, which is going up in New Jersey to $15 an hour, a little more than that. The governor wants it to go even higher. So what do you feel about that? And what kind of minimum wage jobs did you have as a youth? 1-800-283-101.5.
I mean, maybe he's just stupidly thinking out loud, but just stop it. Stop doing that then. Because small business hears him say, he literally said $20 an hour.
Mm-hmm.
$20 an hour for a minimum wage. No state is doing that. And yet, yeah, this is what he's talking about. And as Bill said, also, not only your opinion, but yeah, those jobs that you think about for minimum wage that you had when you were a kid, what were those? Let's talk to Michael in East Brunswick. You're on New Jersey, 101.5.
Yeah, hi, how you doing?
All right,
hey,
Michael.
Hey, Michael, welcome.
Let me tell you something. I love it when you say he thinks stupid. No, he is stupid.
Okay, fair enough. Fair enough.
He wants to make the money. I'm in the automotive business. I have three businesses, all automotive related. Besides the fact that we're already taxed to death and they insured to death, now we're going to be paying. We can't even get skilled laborers. Listen, when I was a kid, I made $3.35 an hour was minimum wage. I'm 60 years old,
mm-hmm.
And I can tell you, I worked hard. And when I wanted to achieve something in life, what did I do? I went to school. I earned. I got a trade. Problem is now in the automotive business, you can't even get somebody to come through the door that has a trade. They change oil. They want 20. You're saying you could raise it as high as $20 an hour. And yet they're not even worthy of making $5 an hour. Because
anybody can do this. That's just it. I mean, you know this, Michael. You're a smart guy, clearly. If anybody off the street within 2 hours could be trained to do the same thing, how is that worth $20?
Yeah, no. And it's just like the guy wrapping burgers at McDonald's. He's wrapping burgers at McDonald's. He should make $20 an hour for what? What skill do you need to do? What do? You wrap the burger wrong, you throw it on the lot. I mean, come on. I mean, you have the problem we have in this country. We're not having enough kids getting involved into a skilled labor where they can at least be, if they're not going to go to school, they at least have some kind of a skill that they can work and achieve things in life. I mean, how do you base your achievement if you don't get an education to go with it? You would think that, you'd want a higher education to get a better job or to have better things in life.
Exactly.
We keep giving. It's just like the pandemic. We gave. And after the pandemic, listen, there's jobs. I see people standing on the corner with a sign, I'm homeless, I'm helpless, I'm this, I'm that. Listen, go get a job at McDonald's. There's a sign up in the window every day, hiring.
Yeah, and that's fine, but Murphy wants those jobs eventually to be $20 an hour.
Yeah.
And you know what? A progressive politician like Murphy, and there are many like him, they want two young people to be able to be married, start pumping out kids, and support those kids by simply wrapping burgers.
Hey, Michael, thanks for calling New Jersey 101.5.
And I'm sorry, you should be wrapping something else and not having the kids.
John and Brick, you're on New Jersey 101.5.
Hey, good evening, guys. How are you?
All right, John.
Hey, John.
So my thing is with the $15 minimum wage now, I feel like now it's about on par to what it was a few years ago at $8 an hour. I feel like that's pretty much where we're at now with the inflation of the economy and all that. My gripe, though, with what he said about going up to $20 an hour
mm-hmm.
is I feel like small businesses, local businesses, what if they can't afford to pay their employees that minimum wage of $20 an hour? And then you have people losing their jobs because the employers can't pay them what the new minimum wage is. And that happened actually to a friend of mine who used to own a local music shop when Obamacare came into play and they mandated all businesses to, you know, have health insurance. He couldn't afford to pay to have health insurance for his employees and his business wound up closing. So how many more businesses would close if that minimum wage went up to $20?
Yeah, there are certain small businesses, and you never wish this for them, but they exist on the edge.
Yeah.
You know, they keep hoping for better times, hoping for a better economy. They're paying their employees before they will even pay themselves. And they're just trying to get by. And you start throwing words like, maybe $20 an hour minimum wage. They just want to give up.
John, thanks for calling. New Jersey 101.5.
Matt on the Turnpike. You're on New Jersey 101.5.
Good evening, gentlemen. Thank you for taking my call.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm a little older than most. I'm 67. I started in the actual paycheck, getting a paycheck when I worked for ShopRite when I was like 15 or 16, and mm-hmm. it was a $1.05 an hour.
Wow.
And we got an extra 5 cents an hour because we worked in the frozen food and the dairy section.
Yep.
They gave us an extra nickel because it was always cold.
Yep.
You know?
Yep.
But $20 an hour, I think that's a little beyond anybody's imagination because, first of all, you can't even get these kids to work. They've been enabled to just sit there and say, oh, I'm here, pay me. No, you got to do work, too. That's part of the deal. They don't do it. They don't want to do it, and they just want to sit home and collect a paycheck. They've been basically just given everything, and the economy can't afford it.
Are you seeing this? I mean, do you have a small business now or just from friends? I mean, are you actually seeing examples of this?
I used to have a small business way back when, and even when I had the small business, and you would get a 20-year-old or an 18-year-old and say, you know, you really don't know much, so here's what we're going to do.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to watch me do what I have to do, and I'm going to hand you some wrenches, and then you're going to show me what you saw and
right.
continue on. And it's like, oh, I can't do that. I can't get dirty. I can't pick up a broom and sweep the floor.
No, really?
Yeah. Wow. Like, have a good day, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. And
that's sad.
And like the previous caller said, it's kind of ties into what Matt is saying. If you want to live the American dream, get a skill. If you don't want to go to college and try and further your life that way, learn a trade. I mean, you can make a very good living and live the American dream if you can learn a trade and just, you know, get off your butt and do something.
Right. And you know what else? They're always going to need you that way, too.
That's right.
A lot of jobs that you could get with a college degree, they may or may not need you. With a trade, almost always, they're going to need you. And you're doing it without a $200,000 student loan.
And AI is not going to be able to replace a plumber.
Yeah. See? Right. Exactly. They might replace a writer. Like, my son is going to college in Vermont. He wants to write.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's a scary time, bro.
Yeah.
You're going to be competing with non-humans, man. All right. We're talking about what Murphy said about the minimum wage. It's going up to $15.13 an hour on January 1st. But he's saying it's not high enough, and he's actually throwing the number $20 an hour around. What do you think of that? And also, what minimum wage job did you have when you were a kid? 1-800-283-101.5.
As the weather gets colder, the NFL offers Stay Hot on FanDuel. Right now, new customers get $150 in bonus bets with any winning $5 moneyline bet. If you've been thinking about joining FanDuel, there's no better time to get in on the action, because that's $150 if your team wins. Please sign up now. Get their app, download it, place your first bet, place a bet on tonight's game. They have a wide range of betting options. They have the spreads, they have the player props, they have the same game parlays, they have over-unders, and many, many more different types of betting options, so you can find one you like. So visit FanDuel.com/Doyle and kick off the NFL season. You need that promo code to get that offer. That's FanDuel.com/Doyle. FanDuel, official partner of the NFL. Must be 21 and older, present in New Jersey. First online real money wager only. $5 pregame money line wager required. $10 first deposit required. Bonus issued as non-withdrawable bonus bets that expire 7 days after receipt. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
Hey, we need bears, okay? Teddy bears. Station collects these with the New Jersey State PBA this time of year, and they're called Feel Better Bears. Your gift of a new teddy bear can help a kid feel better during emergencies when the police give them a bear to hug. That's the idea. To find your closest Feel Better Bear drop-off location or to buy a bear online, visit our app or nj1015.com. Big thanks to All American Auto Group, Rob Dukansky of RE/MAX First Advantage is part of this, also Trinity Rehab. This holiday, give a child a Feel Better Bear, and thanks from New Jersey 101.5.
651 with Deminski and Doyle coming up after 7 o'clock. It's Edelstein and Clark after dark.
Mm.
Yeah. Different combination.
Yeah. Doesn't roll quite off the tongue, but it's okay. We got there.
Yeah,
we got there.
Edelstein has too many syllables.
Exactly. But that's coming up.
Yes. But right now we're talking about minimum wage.
Let's talk to John in Voorhees. You're in a Jersey 101.5. Hey, John.
Hi, gentlemen. How are you?
Fine, thanks.
I think the reason why he's doing it, he's just looking for additional tax revenue. And so obviously there is a way around it if you're an employer and you have several employees. So what you do, you fire one. If you're paying them both $15 an hour, just keep one on the $20 an hour. Either that or you pay them under the table. And I think what he's doing is shooting himself in the foot. And as far as my first job, I worked in a drive-through convenience store where I made $1.55 an hour.
And we added the produce up and the milk and the bread. We added up on a piece of paper and we put it in the cash register. And when I got my paycheck, I thought I was rich. I worked like 20 hours a week.
Yeah, yeah. And these were the kinds of jobs back then that you would expect. This is, you know, I don't have years of work experience. I'm going to learn basically almost how to work.
How to be an employee.
Right. And you were okay with that minimum wage.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And you learn responsibility.
Right.
And I think now,
and you weren't trying to raise kids on it.
Well, yeah, that's right. That's exactly right. And now what he's trying to do, I think he's looking for the tax revenue, and this could very well put some businesses out of business.
Which is going to hurt him in the long run with tax revenue.
All right, yeah. John, thanks for your call.
Lynn in Milltown, you're on New Jersey, 101.5.
Hi, how are you?
Okay.
Hi.
Hi. So I called the other day about the thing with the bumper stickers and stuff like that. So I don't know if you remember me or not, but I'm calling.
Oh, wait, the one about the bumper stickers. Yeah. Hey, how you been?
Put in the trunk. Yeah. Hey. This is such an interesting conversation because when I was in high school, my parents made me work after high school so that I could, if I wanted clothes, like I had to pay for them. So I was paid $5 an hour and I work at a dry cleaner's. And I would have to go through the pockets of pants. And I mean, it was literally like one guy had like fingernails and toenails in there. I don't even know.
Oh, no. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me right now?
No, you can't make this up. No.
And you have to clear that out of there before it went through the chemical processing.
No, yes. I would have to, just in case somebody had like change in their pocket or, you know, money or jewelry, then I would put it aside. This one has like some type of nail. I'm not sure.
That's so, okay, could I ask you something? This really has nothing to do with a minimum wage, but it's just a fun question. I too did that for a short time, but I worked for a guy. I don't know if this is normal in the business or not, but the guy who ran the dry cleaning shop, he told us if you ever found like a couple of bucks in somebody's pocket that we could keep it. Did they?
No.
No, you were supposed to turn it in?
We never had that discussion, but I would not. No, I was so, and I wouldn't even do it to this day. But I guess now I still. I don't know.
This guy outright told us, and I guess it was his way of like, well, it's not coming out of my pocket.
Yeah, as a perk for you.
Yep, he would like encourage us, if you find money, just go ahead and keep it, which wasn't really ethical, but that's what he did.
All right, Lynn, thanks for your call. We got to go. As we mentioned, Edelstein and Clark are up next. We'll be back tomorrow from 2 to 7 with our end-of-the-week game at 6 o'clock on New Jersey 101.5.
This has been the Deminski and Doyle Show on demand. Thanks to our sponsor, New Look Home Design. Home improvement made easy. Check out the latest from D&D on our app or NJ1015.com. Thanks to our sponsor, The Men with Tools. Worry-proof window and door replacement. Real lifetime warranties. Visit TheMenWithTools.com. New Jersey 101.5.